Hello and welcome to a new episode of Iron Valor. I am your host, Daniel Hodges, and we are excited for a Pirate's Life for Me, an amazing little game that is Iron Valor. So for those of you who don't know, Iron Valor is an arena show where our players fight some of the biggest, baddest monsters in Dungeons & Dragons 5th Edition, and then test their skills against one another. We do this, and it's a lot of fun. We try to have a good time, and it is a blast for everyone. So, a couple announcements before we get started. First things first, we've added a few new additions to the Iron Valor Redemption Tokens. This week, in addition to giving your coins away to all your players, you'll also be able to give luck points and also give blessings and curses. Now, not everyone's going to be able to buy one, or not everyone will be able to buy one, but you won't be able to buy multiples of these. But just to give you a heads up, we're looking at things into phase three that can really change the outcome of the battle. For instance, you can give the entire blue team or the entire red team a bonus to their AC, or you can have them double their movement. And those are rolled randomly on our side of things. So those will be super fun, and you'll be able to help your favorite team win if you so choose. You earn valor, and you can buy these things. You can buy these blessings and these curses by earning valor tokens. You earn valor tokens by watching us here, following, subscribing, all that kind of fun stuff. Going past that, it is now September. So if you are not following or subscribed to the stream, you can go ahead and do so. During the month of September, you can get up to 30% off on all your subs. Of course, if you're a Prime member, you can subscribe to us and help support the channel. And it doesn't cost you anything. It's just your sub there. And then we are giving away a new t-shirt during the break, or at the break, we'll start a giveaway for the Tail Weavers shirt. Let me see if I can show that to all of you real quick. Super cool. One of my favorites. One that most people seem to like. Yeah, it's got the really cool D20 with the webs and everything in there. So go check that out. That's available on our store, but we're giving one away tonight. So as you're watching,
yes, during the break.
Yeah, during the break, we'll be giving one of those away. So, super duper fun. And, of course, I want to thank our guest players for joining us this evening. Lauren Hodges, our DM for Fate's End.
And, hey, darlings.
And Mr. Jesse Wolf, welcome to the show.
Hey, how's it going?
Pretty good, pretty good. All right. Then, last but not least, we have a new oracle for the evening. Can we hear her?
Greetings, champions. May the favor of the blood gods be upon you.
I love it.
All right. Good luck, everyone else. all right. And so with that, I think that wraps up our announcements. So, let's get into tonight's episode of Iron Valor. The North Sea above Aurora is a warm and tropical place. The winds cut through your hair, the saltiness of the sea comes up into your nostrils, and the wind in the sails carries you towards Sunspell, where Iron Valor is held. Today, you look around the bow of the ship and see all of your many crewmates. Brandon, do you want to start us off with what your character looks like?
You're looking at a Theodore Sex. He is a water genasi sorcerer. He looks pretty relaxed on this ship here. He's wearing some nice loose fitting pants. He's got a tank top kind of shirt. He's got tattoos that look like waves coming down one of his arms, and he wears a headband over his messy seafaring hair. It's got salt all in it and stuff, and he's blue.
Blue. What class did you pick today?
Sorcerer.
Sorcerer. Okay. Davis.
This be your captain speaking. I'll be playing Captain Gruel. He's a warforged. He's been on the seas many, many years. His weather-beaten mixture of silvery and dull, dark, metallic exoskeleton is crusted with sea brine. He wears a captain's greatcoat that's been tattered from many battles. His eyes glow. One of them is red. The other is yellow, as if they've been recently exchanged. And he stands proudly at the helm of his ship. He's a fifth level swashbuckler rogue and a first level fighter, as well as a first level sorcerer. And he's taken the resilient charisma.
All of the multi-classes. Let's round out Team Blue. James.
I am playing Yar Lukesh, who is a Simic hybrid. Very dark blue skin. He's wearing a tattered cloak. He's got a sword, or an axe, and a shield. And he is rocking resilient charisma as a fighter sorcerer.
Fighter sorcerer. Alrighty. Team Red, Dylan.
I got Patches. He's in a rugged jacket with patches in it, as well as rugged shorts also with patches in them. He has an eye patch because he followed his captain in a battle and lost his eye.
I remind ye, I lost my eye too. I just replaced it.
Yeah, well, some of us didn't get to steal all the treasure. But anyways, aside from that, I am a ranger, and I have taken crossbow expert, and I am of the sea elf race.
The sea elf. Wolf.
Arr, I'm ye ship's artificer, and I be Stump, the 300-pound roly-poly pirate with two peg legs. And luck on my side. I'm the smith of ye ship, with me trusty rusted metal parrot named Crank. And together, we are Stump and Crank.
I love it.
Crank. Yes.
I love it. Stump and Crank. Love it. Stump and Crank. And Lauren, who are you playing?
You gaze upon Iveria, the scorned siren reefborn. Triton Lorbard, first mate, her long purple hair pulls down over her shoulders, contrasted against her lighter pale purple, almost fuchsia skin. Her eyes are a radiant turquoise, under each eye a black lined tattoo that lines each lid and drips down to a point. Her right ear is pierced with a gold chain draping down from each piercing. She dons a red overcoat cinched with a black leather corset and gold buckles around her waist. As her overcoat flows around with her gait, you'd see that she also has thigh-high leather boots. You notice a golden coral, rough necklace wreathed upon her neck, a long rapier with obsidian black metal forged filigree. The metal looks like black tentacles twisting around the grip and the hilt strapped on her hip. You also see dangling around her waist a gold coin in a foreign language, a cork with a symbol burned into it, a rusted small broken circular mirror, a very small leather cylinder, and other trinkets. But they're hard to see. I look to my team, my red team compatriots, and I yell, "Boom about, gents! Bring a spring upon her cable! Sing with me now! Come all you young sailor men, listen to me, and I'll sing you a song of the fish in the sea, and it's windy weather, boy, stormy weather, boys, when the wind blows, we're all together, boys.
Blow ye winds westerly, blow ye winds blow, jolly southwesterly,
steady we go.
She goes.
Ye not remind me why I don't see.
It is a wonderful serenade of the sea shanty, and the harmonious, you know, music goes on the sea as you all make your way towards Sunspell and towards the Iron Valor, and you move in. Maybe there was something wrong with the sea shanty, because as you begin to look around, all of you, you see in the water approaching the coast, you can see just on the horizon is the city, and looming in the water, a gray fin begins to rise out of the ocean and start swimming towards you. A massive shark comes swimming your direction, moving and circling and coming towards all of you.
And support, that's gents.
And then on the wind, you can see there's these small little faint dots, look like seagulls, start flying towards you. The flapping of their wings is audible, which is so strange for small little seagulls. And that's when you realize, coming from the west and far too far away, are two leathery type wings and scales, red on top with a white chest, as two wyverns start making their way towards the boat as well. What do you do?
I bring the ship to port. I'm in speed, laddies.
The sharks moving in the water. You can see all the cannons that face out, but you're not really sure if they're necessarily built for this situation right now. Let's go ahead and roll initiative.
But maybe first, champions, the blood gods have spoken. Dappergent 13 has bestowed a point of luck to Team Red.
A point of luck to Team Red. Thank you, Dapper Gent 13. Luck is on your side this day, Stumpy. All right. Let's get into this.
Captain, I can't see him.
Go ahead.
Brother, damn I.
Who's taking this luck?
Yeah, who wants the luck?
You or him.
I'll take it if no one
wants. Lauren, you take the luck.
Lauren's luck.
Lauren takes the luck. All right, let's go ahead and get these initiative rolls in.
All right. Boom. Awesome.
I think this guy Beautiful. Looks like he's like, this shark looks like he's like upside down. Okay. All righty. So 25 to 20.
Awesome.
Great. 15 to 20.
Your
Ooh.
Captain be rolling in with a
17. Oh, Captain. Captain, leading initiative for this group. Captain. 15, or 10 to 15.
Oh. 13.
Stop it.
I got 10.
And what'd you have, Yar?
12.
Yar.
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 10 for your boy. For patches.
Couldn't see him, Captain.
5 to 10.
Theodore rolled an 8. He wasn't paying attention.
1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Alright, who are we missing?
Boren.
Iveria. Iveria with a 10? Mm-hmm. Okay. Patches, you and Iveria, roll off.
I got a 10.
Another 10.
I rolled an 8.
Okay. Alrighty. So, as you begin, you see these large wyverns start moving across the sea, and the shark is coming at you. It seems like they're coming to attack this ship specifically, and you're not really sure why, but things are not about to go well. Top of the round, this wyvern comes swooping down and tries to grapple you, Iveria, with its first attack. Make it an athletics or acrobatics check, your choice.
I'm sorry, I didn't hear you. The dog was going crazy.
Make an athletics or acrobatics check, your choice.
Athletics or acrobatics?
Mm-hmm.
Athletics, definitely.
Sure, go for it. As the swing swings down and tries to scoop you up.
That's no bueno.
That'll miss. So as you do, it grabs you. Iveria, you're grabbed with both claws as the wyvern picks you up and then starts flying over and gets ready. And it'll hold you out over the water as it starts to fly away.
Oh, snap.
That'll end its turn. Captain!
Pigeon!
He put down me first mate and... Just kind of whacks first on his left arm and a metallic shield fans out into an existence. Clang! And then he takes his other hand and it reverts and he like smashes the ground next to him and like a cannonball rolls into his grip and he goes, "Eat this, ya great landlubber!" And fires a cannonball at this wyvern using the catapult spell.
At Wyvern 1?
Yep.
Okay, flying through the air. Go ahead and make an attack roll.
Dex save.
Ooh, a dex save. Oh goodness, I'm sure this wyvern's super good at that. That's a natural 3, so I'm sure that fails.
Kerpow. You be eating lead tonight, laddie.
Eating the lead.
Ooh. Thought there'd be 19 damage.
19 damage.
Ooh.
All right. So the
back out.
So the cannonball comes flying out, just hits him square in the ribs. You feel a couple. It looks like a couple of them break as he's like screeches down there. Ah! I don't know what rhymes sound like, but and then the grip starts to loosen on Iveria. That's action. Bonus action.
Can I use a bonus action and steer this here ship?
You could certainly try. You want to turn it towards the shark?
Actually, I kind of want to give that shark a full broadside. Bring us alongside.
Okay, so you start to turn the ship and move it over and kind of swing port here. Port. And move around. Stumpy!
What be your orders, Captain? And as yelling that, I'm going to walk toward there, and then I'm going to pull up a shield that looks like a giant bird beak and pull out a pepper box over the top of it and take 2 shots at the wyvern.
All right. Wyvern.
Is Wyvern 1 above the deck?
Not right now. He pulled out away from the deck.
Then I'll fire it at Wyvern 2.
Another pepper box. Cross the sky. Roll it ahead, buddy.
That is a... 14.
14 hits. as you shoot the second wyvern with the first shot.
That would be 11 points of damage.
You can see the pepper box, it kind of spreads out and shoots through a couple of the wings as it peppers into this wyvern with 11 points of damage.
The exact same thing.
Another 14, that'll hit for sure. Another one, both sides, bah, bah! It's starting to lose some height now as it starts to flap its way down.
That one would be 9 points of damage.
9 points of damage. All right. Bonus action.
Nothing on this turn.
Alrighty, that'll end it. Yar!
Orders! Gunners, Yar. Bring down these winged monstrous birds! Boarders, lash that shark and prepare to board it!
Okay, we're doing that.
Board the shark. Board the shark, let's go! Yar!
Sounds good. With that, I will not run up with Stumpy, but I will run back over here. I will also face Wyvern 2 and pull my shield out. And I will call out to Stumpy. Thank you for teaching me some of this. And I will pull out an ethereal gun. And I will take a shot at the Wyvern.
Boom! It comes flying out. This ethereal kind of gun appears from your hand and just like it's destiny, the golden gun. Straight through the air. Roll
it. You truly spoiled me with this ranged weaponry.
Arr, as long as you leave me from a nap.
Yeah, I'll try not to hit you.
What'd you roll?
No, I did not hit it. That is terrible.
That'll miss. Natural 3. That'll miss, unfortunately.
I didn't hit Stump. It was close, though.
You did not. That'll go.
Aiming down.
Goes wide.
We're good. Bonus action. Bonus action, I will manifest an echo of myself.
The Echo Knight. Alright. Where is that gonna go?
It'll go basically over by Sax. 15 feet away from me.
Okay. By Sax?
Yes.
There's two of them now.
I'll put you right here. As an echo of Yar appears. All right, that'll end your turn. That'll bring us down to the shark. The shark is gonna swim under the water. You see the fin disappear, and then you feel the whole boat rock as the entire right side of this boat, the port side of this boat, gets flipped up in the air and like it rises and flips. Awesome. I need everyone on that side of the boat to make a dexterity saving throw. That's Yar and Theodore. As the tail of the shark is smashed into the boat, knocking it up in the air.
Yeah, 10.
Dex save?
Dexterity saving throw, yeah.
Ooh, that's not good.
Oh, no.
That's only a 7.
Ooh, 7. That's not good.
Don't do this to me. Not today.
Please. Not today.
The boat is going to take... the boat takes 58 points of bludgeoning damage as the shark smashing
damage.
And then what'd you roll, Yar?
10.
Yar, you and Theater both fall overboard into the water and see this. The shark is the largest shark you've ever seen. It's probably 40 feet long. It's as wide around as it's probably 15 feet around, and it's smiling at you all, and it's swimming under the boat, and it's coming for both of you. As the boat rocks up, you fall in, it comes back down, and you're both in the water now.
Okay,
that'll end the shark's turn. Patches,
Captain, we've lost 2 members of our ship.
And overboard.
I want to go mount the shark, but I gotta help. I gotta help Iveria.
You're a gunner, you daft fool.
Much obliged, love.
Yes, she's
following Captain Order. I mark the wyvern as my prey.
Okay.
It's bonus action. I take two shots with my crossbow. All these youngins relying on new fancy weaponry. I stick old school.
Flying through the air, just.
All right, Astral won't work for me, but I have backups.
Backups, let's hear them.
I got a 16, Captain.
That hits.
And another high number, Captain.
Another high number. Go and roll that damage.
Not that high. It's good enough.
I can't get that high. I can only see with one eye.
I can see one eye, and I can only use one of my hands, one of my toes. No, any more than 10. Can't do it. The boat has 200 hit points.
Oh, no.
Had 200.
24 damage, Captain.
24 damage to the Wyvern 2. And with that, that is enough. And so as you come over their patches and you shoot two, they both hit right into the thigh of this Wyvern. And you can see it starts to bleed this kind of dark red crimson. It lets go of Iveria. Iveria, you start to fall into the water. You fall about 40 feet and smash into the water below. Are you... make an acrobatics check.
Take command of the overboarders!
I don't... Yeah, I was about to...
don't worry, right. She's a dumb fish.
Darling, I can swim. I can breathe underwater. You, Captain, of course, cannot.
Captain, she can still hear you.
Ah! I'm falling. Okay. You said acrobatics?
Yeah, make an acrobatics check.
That's straight roll.
I ain't gonna do it. You gotta do the whole
thing.
Perfect. Whoa. Perfect. So, what does it look like as you fall from this wyvern and gracefully land into the sea?
Iveria would like to attempt to unleash her rapier and attempt to stab it into the ship as she goes down. And if she can't do that, she's gonna try to do it anyways. And just kind of like pencil dive in, as water is her native environment. And she'll be like, be back, loves.
So as you do, it scrapes the side of the boat. It doesn't quite rip like you want to, but slows you down and gets you into a perfect spot as you drop 15 or 20 feet into the water. And you look across and you see Yar and Theodore and a shark that is now twisted and turned and looks at them. And you now see the 40-foot bus of a shark in here in the water.
That's not good.
Who's the shark? Which way is the shark facing? Towards Yar or towards Theodore?
Right now, towards both of you. Like, it's swinging around. Okay. And that brings around to Iveria's turn. What do you do?
Iveria would like to attempt to climb back onto the ship with her movement, if that is possible.
Sure. It'll take your full action to get all the way up there, but you can get back on the boat.
Okay. But I need to get back on the boat. I don't want to be in this water.
It's like, all right.
I climb myself with my like a dagger and maybe like my other rapier, and I climb up the side of the ship like a friggin' Spartan warrior, and like I grab Patch's arm to help me out, like, and swing my leg over the ship and just kind of like flip my hair over, like, see, I was fine. I told you I was fine.
Absolutely graceful, madam.
Perfect.
That's why she's first mate and you're Patches.
Hey, I talk back, but I only have one eye.
Oh, Lord.
What? That'll end your turn, Iveria. Wyvern 2, sensing the danger from all these, from Stump and all of these range characters, will fly straight down and come at you, Stump. And you see it careens at you. It's going to try to make a bite attack, and it lands on the ship and bites at you. That's going to be a 13 plus something.
I'm going to crank B, start picking at the wyvern as it tries to attack you, Stumpy. And it now has disadvantage.
Ooh, disadvantage on this attack. So that's an 11.
Does not hit. Stop me.
So it'll land, it kind of crouches, and you see the tail come up flying, and then that will come at you as well. Is it both attacks or just the first?
Just the one.
Just the one. Oh, that is a 16.
Nope, not even close.
Not even close. As it comes in and just psh, hits on that shield, that walker of a shield that you have. Just chink, blocks.
You remind me of Mule Maid. Oh, wrinkly and so.
And then it'll rise up about and fly about 30 or 40 feet in the air. Get off the ground. That'll end its turn. Theodore.
Oh. All right. I'm going to go fight this guppy of a shark we have, Gillen.
Yeah.
Theodore ain't making it out of Valor.
being a water genasi, he is also right at home in the crashing wave. So he's going to swim over to the shark. And as he does, his tattoo sleeve is going to start glowing this like purple black color as he casts inflict wounds and grabs one of the shark's fins.
Is that a save?
No, it's a melee spell attack.
Okay, let's get it.
Okay, let's get it. Come on, Astro. Come on, Astro. Okay, it's hang on. No, I got it. Just roll on here. Okay, that's gonna be a 16.
A 16. 16 does hit the shark.
Fantastic. All right. And that's 3d10 necrotic damage as the black light that is gleaming from his tattoo shoots into his fingertips and then spreads throughout the shark in like a weird electrical pattern.
And it's almost like the arm tattoo matches the tattoo, a temporary tattoo on the shark as it reaches out. What kind of damage are you dealing with here?
Necrotic. That's 16 damage.
All right. 16 necrotic damage to this shark.
Yes.
All right. Perfect. That's action. Bonus action?
Bonus action. Can I misty step back onto the ship as a bonus action? My 30 feet?
I think it's a little bit too high. As far as where your movement is, I don't think you could quite get there. You could probably get onto the side of the ship and like hang there. I don't know if you could get all the way up.
I think I'd have a better chance trying to get onto the ship, so I'm gonna do that.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you missed your
here.
Wait, inflict wounds is a spell, isn't it? First level spell?
It's a touch spell.
But it's a first level spell, right? It's not a cantrip, right?
No, it's not a cantrip. It's not a cantrip.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Because I'm a sorcerer.
That's right. Okay. So you misty step, you get closer. I'm going to say you can get about 5 feet out of the water and begin climbing, but you've used a lot of movement to get where you are. So okay. You're moving up the boat, but that's it.
Cool.
That'll end your turn and bring us around to the top of the round as the wyvern will swing down and attack Patches. Couple attacks coming at you, my boy. That is going to be a 9 and a 26 with the poison tail. So the bite comes at you as it's flapping. You can feel the wind against you as it's kind of throwing that out. You knock the first one away, but the second one, the tail comes flying out and gets you underneath. Make a constitution saving throw.
Constitution. Patches is good at these. Mm-hmm. A natural 20 it is.
A natural 20? Ooh. Is it really?
It actually is. I had to roll. I don't know why, but I can try and roll a natural. It doesn't let me for some reason.
I can't see anybody's rolls right now.
Oh, for real?
Yeah.
It's freezing up.
All right, you take 10 piercing damage and 14 poison damage for a total of 24 as it smashes into you. And you can feel it get into your system a little bit, but then you just resist it, you know, because Patches.
Stay away from me eyes, will ye? I only got one left.
All right, natural 20. That'll end Wyvern, and then Wyvern 1 will... get back out over the water a little bit, pull away from you guys, and be about 10 or 20, 30 feet off the ground. And then in his turn, Captain.
What I have planned. How far is the Wyvern number 2 away from me?
Probably, because you're a step up over there. I'd say he's no more than like probably 25, 30 feet away.
Interesting. These things seem pretty strong there.
What are you doing, Captain?
I'm gonna do it again. It seemed to work pretty good last time. Hand retracts again, pulls over another cannonball. He's like, this time you're closer, you dumbass.
It's a 17 to save.
17 should save. Yes, yes.
Does it just go wide?
It goes in a straight line for a real long way. That's what it does.
off into the air, going straight up. You see it goes through one of the sails. There's a giant hole in it now, but it keeps going and going and going and going, off into nothingness.
Don't worry, mates. This isn't the first time Captain's missed.
Waves his hand. Come down here and taste my blade, you great winged bastard.
Obliged. Stumpy.
I reach down to me parrot legs, unhinge them, and start to bounce up and down as they are spring-loaded. Ah, you thought I'd be easy prey, matey. I'm going to cast Blur on myself.
Blur.
Crank, be angry well at the wyverns. Well, small-mindedness. And here, apply the help action for anyone else who looks to attack it.
Nice.
Something has happened. Luck.
That was a beautiful.
Okay. Love it.
Spring-loaded peg legs.
That was beautiful.
Only on Iron Valor, ladies and gentlemen.
Spring-loaded peg legs. Love it.
Blood God Dapper Gent 13 has spoken once again and has bestowed a point of luck to Team Blue.
Ooh. Yeah. Luck to Team Blue. Who wants that on that side?
James, I feel like either you or I should. You sure?
Take it, yeah.
Yeah, I'm gonna take it. Okay.
Okay.
James, just the Dapper Gent needs his knees checked.
Yar's like, I got this.
I got this. We're supposed to board the shark, right?
Yeah.
Why are you getting on the boat?
Let's find out. As Stumpy, begins to vibrate like wildly. Yar, it's your turn.
Oh. Okay. Alrighty. So as my free action, I'm gonna move my Echo to the edge of the ship.
Okay.
Beautiful. And then how far do I have to go to reach this shark?
So this shark is probably like 20 or 30 feet down underneath the ocean, and you're about 15 feet. He's probably about 15 to 20 feet away from you.
It's 15 feet. So he's not breaching the surface.
No. He hit the boat from the bottom, knocked all of you out, and then now he's coming back up.
We can't board a shark underwater. That's
mount him, mate!
Mount him?
You mount the shark.
I'm swimming down to the shark.
You swim down to the shark.
I'm gonna attack him.
He swims to you as well, mouth wide open. Alright, you roll to hit, or whatever you're doing.
Yeah, I'm gonna just start swinging at him and just yelling at him. It's great. How big is this shark?
Like 40 feet long.
Okay, we're good.
I'm going straight for the shark. How big
is it? Yeah, I'm going for the shark. So sure. The first attack is 1d4.
24 hits, yeah.
The second attack is not a 24, it's a 14.
14 hits too.
Let's see. We will do 9 points of damage on that one, 15 points of damage on that one, and we will action surge.
Ooh, okay, okay, okay.
We're getting all Yari in here.
So as you come across the first two attacks, come into, what are you wielding? A sword or what you got?
I'm wielding a battle axe.
Okay, so you're currently underwater. So that first attack hits, make another attack.
Make a double attack?
Yeah, because they're with a disadvantage.
Okay.
So both those attacks still hit.
Cool.
Action surge, and again.
Yar! just straight through them. Let's go for two more attacks. At disadvantage with an 18 and a 20.
Not a natural 20. This shark is getting tore up.
Oh no. Does a 12 hit?
12 misses.
Oh. This shark. I hit him one more time.
It is a powerful, like, the water doesn't even mess with Yar. He swings the great axe through the water. It almost looks like he's about to stab him directly in the eye or up the nose like you're supposed to do with sharks.
11 points. No, I'm going for his teeth. His dental work.
Rude. He has a great smile. And he'll show you that now as he'll make his attacks.
Whoa, hold on. How far away from my echo am I?
You are
at... How far up is it?
At least 40, 50 feet.
Okay.
I have it dive in after you.
Help me!
Because that echoes on top of the boat.
Okay, and how far did I swim down? 15 feet, you said?
Well, then you swam down to the shark, which was like 30 feet.
Okay, so I did my full movement down to the shark?
Most of it, because you have a swim speed?
Yeah.
You do? So you probably have like 5 or 10 feet.
Okay, not enough. Should I just like brace for the shark's toothy maw?
Probably.
Oh, no.
I just curl up in a ball, ready to go inside the shark.
The shark is going to make is the so with that taking all this damage, the shark will now try to bite at you, Yar, and take his two attacks.
Yar.
Have you taken damage yet?
Point, homie.
I have not taken damage.
Okay, so first attack. Oh no, that's gonna miss probably with a 13.
Yeah.
And second, I'm not rolling super well tonight.
Perfect. Imagine that.
And then a 22 to hit.
22 hits.
All right. So
I missed that set of teeth.
You missed the first set because he goes to bite at you and you just the great axe gets into his teeth and he bites down on it and it like gets him from the inside. The second attack comes through. You take 36 points of piercing damage and you are grappled by the creature and he starts to swim further down with you.
So he came up to me and then he's going back down now.
Now he's going to pull you further down. If you can, you can breathe underwater.
Yeah.
Great. So he's biting you, and he's gonna bring you down further, and keep chomping. That'll end his turn. Patches.
Aye, birds. I won't be caught over here on the ship, and I jump overboard.
Whew. Gracefully diving into the water. You look down. You see Yars being dragged like. He's at this point, he's like 60 or 70 feet down. Blood is trailing him the whole way from this shark.
My God, mate, what are you doing? I said for you to mount him, not for him to mount you. I move forward to mount the shark.
That shark is like 90 feet away from you.
I said I move forward.
That's what I'm talking about.
Patches underneath the ship. Moves diagonally towards the shark as they get deeper and further forward at the same time.
Go Patches, go.
Go Patches. You're underneath the boat swimming towards it. You got anything
Let
else?
Let go of me, mate, will ya? And I fire two crossbow bolts at him.
What's the range on your crossbow bolts?
How does crossbow expert work? Does it give me... I don't know. I've never used it. Did they ignore the range feat? Or is that only sharpshooter? Because it's sharpshooter.
So with underwater, it's if it's past the first minimum range, it just misses.
It's 100.
Okay, you're within range. Roll to hit.
All right.
Oh.
I mark him bonus action. Mark him as a hunter. My hunted mark.
Hunter mark. Move the hunter's mark from him to that one, and roll to hit.
I have two different marks.
What?
They're both marked, mate. I don't want to kill them both.
All the marks, matey.
I have but two bullets.
Alright, roll to hit, Patches.
My eyesight isn't so good. Let's see. Oh, mate, am I not hit? That's a 15?
15 does hit. No problem.
Ah, yes. And a 14.
14 also hits the shark.
Ah, yes. He will take... Oh, that's good. That's good damage right there.
Oh, that's good damage. Avast.
I rolled the wrong dice. See, oh my god, it's good damage. We rolled a plus four, plus four. Math is in me strong suit. 33 damage he takes.
43 damage. That's a lot of damage.
No, okay. That's a lot of damage.
43 damage. All right, that'll end your turn there, y'all. Patches, Iveria.
Seeing Patches swan dive into the into the murky depths of the ocean, she'll just kind of like give him like the Godspeed as he jumps in, and she'll look up at the wyvern, and she'll say, "How very bold of you, pigeon, to fly so very far in the middle of the ocean with only one thing to land on." And she'll just kind of like raise her arm a little bit, and like this dark blackness will seep and it'll align with the tattoos underneath her eyes. And she will begin to cast a spell, and she'll say, "I will drag you into the depths and your entrails will be fed to that shark." And she will cast Dissonant Whispers. So that's a wisdom saving throw for the wyvern.
The wyvern rolled a 3 on his wisdom saving throw.
That is a fail.
Which is a 4 total.
So like with the success of this, everyone on deck would see this kind of dark blackness kind of like begin to envelop the head and the eyes of this creature. But what the wyvern sees are these black tentacles kind of coming out of the ocean in an attempt to drag it down into the ocean. And
it's like the Eldritch just kind of tentacles pulling it down.
Yes. That is 23 psychic damage.
Ooh.
And because it did fail, it must immediately use its reaction, if available, to move as far as its speed will allow away from me.
Wow, okay. All right, it flies 80 feet back towards the mainland. God.
Does it pee itself?
I mean, there's a trickle of wyvern pee as it moves out. And it starts flying and just... starts heading
away
from this.
And then she'll just be like, "Farewell, darling."
I feel like I'm gonna get clipped, and I hate everything. all right, so that'll end. I'm going to say with that, this wyvern, there's a certain the way his hit points are, and there's a certain like bestial instinct there with everything that's happened. This wyvern flies off and it keeps going.
Yeah,
and it's just
phew,
gone out of here. And you,
I wanted to eat that.
And that wyvern is gone as I very reborn.
Oh, and I want to inspire someone.
All right, inspire.
Can I inspire? You're probably not going to let me, like the people in the water, they can't hear me or see.
They,
right?
You can't see them, but you can do Captain or Stumpy.
I mean, I'm hanging off the boat. I could probably hear.
She can't see you.
I can't see you, though.
Okay. She doesn't know you're there, you know?
I will inspire my good comrade Stump, and I will sing, "Way, hey, and up she rises. Way, way hey, hey, and up she rises. Way, hey, and up she rises early in the morning. What do we do with the drunken sailor? What do we do with the drunken sailor?"
Aye, your voice be pleasing upon the winds.
Perfect. Amazing. Thank you. Thank you for that, Iveria. All right, Wyvern 2 will come towards Captain. Show off a little bit. Bite coming at you, Captain. That is a 15 to hit.
You're funny, stinking bird. And he like slides his shield in edgewise and then extends it so like its maw just catches on his shield.
Bites it.
And then drops the shield and lets it fly off. Try again.
The tail comes around from the bottom with a 13, or not a, that would be a 20 total.
20 will hit.
So as you hold up the shield and grab it in place, its maw just kind of trying to rip that out. The poison tail stinger underneath comes up and gets you right underneath the breastplate. Go ahead and make a constitution saving throw.
Constitution saving throw, and I will uncanny dodge this.
Okay. So
That there be a 14.
That saves. I think you can uncane dodge all of it. So that will be a total of 40, halved to 20. Or no, no, sorry. 11, 14, 25, 12. 12 points of damage total between piercing and, 12 points of damage between piercing and poison as it comes up and gets you right in the gut.
As I see it, the whip of motion with my eyes, one turns, and I manage to like half parry it, but it's too whippy and it just kind of digs into my plate. And I give it a look like, is this poison? I'm resistant to that. And throw out
resistant
my
again.
Turn next.
Perfect.
Hey, Game Master, I think he Stumpy gets a attack of opportunity as the beast tries to run away from me.
You could have taken one before, so yeah, go for it. He was too high then, but you could have taken one before. Go for it.
That'd be 22.
No problem. Roll that damage, Stumpy. As the wire, all this is happening, it's like, I'm resistant to that. You are vast. And Stumpy's like, yeah, he is. I don't know. Shoots him.
That'd be 6 points of damage.
Additional 6. Love it. Okay. All right, that'll end the Wyvern's turn. Theodore!
How much of that damage was poison?
29. I think it comes out to like 9. Because it's halved. Yeah, rogues suck. Go ahead. Go ahead, Theodore.
All right. Theodore, hanging from the edge of the ship, he looks around trying to see if Yar's going to resurface. And not no. seeing him for what he thinks is far too long, he has to go save his shipmate. So he takes a deep breath, more like a sigh of like a sigh of resignation, and he dives into the water after the shark.
Yar.
Do I have enough movement? I've got 30 feet of a swim speed. Do I have enough movement to get to him from where I was?
No. He's like, at this point, they're like 70 feet down.
Okay. Can I see them?
You can.
Fantastic. All right. So, not being able to get into melee range with him, once again, Sax will hold up his arm. His tattoo will glow, and he will cast Mind Thrust on the shark. That is an intelligence save of 13 that he has.
Smart be the shark.
Smart is real shark. Shark is real shark. That's a natural 5, which comes out to a 0.
Fantastic.
Oh, the shark is not very intelligent, I see.
All right, so this time the tattoo glows like a kind of a milky white color, and Theodore's gonna like point his fingers like a gun and then fire the mind spike directly into the shark. As it makes contact with the shark's brain, he takes 3d6 points of damage. Let me go ahead and roll that.
If you have a 1 intelligence, you should be immune to psychic damage.
He takes this, 8
means you have a brain.
Takes 8 points of damage from the mind thrust, and he can't take a reaction until the end of its next turn. And on its next turn, it must choose whether it gets a move, an action, or a bonus action, and it only gets 1 of the 3.
Okay, it's got a bad headache.
Yeah,
right now. All right, that'll end it. That will end your turn, Theodore. Wyvern Run 1 continues to fly and is gone. And we'll use this action to double dash. It's now a football field away and is out of here. Captain!
Tell your friends.
Am I in melee with the Wyvern?
It's like 15, 20 feet away from you, yeah.
Oh. I lightning lure it.
Ooh.
Lightning lure. I don't know what that is.
So
I've never seen anyone get to use it.
I normally reserve this for patches, but you've been a bad bird. I flick out this tendril of energy and lash it. I need to make a strength saving throw.
from the Wyvern. That's good. 16 plus something. 20 total.
Yeah, it's okay. It's okay.
Oh, our captain.
It's hard to whip something above you. That's why I'm on the upper deck.
That'd be a nice try, Captain.
Come down here.
Stumpy is silently judging you for your lack of competence. I wonder if there's it's like dissension. That's action. Bonus action.
And he'll just kind of like take out a dial from his pocket and like twist into his check, and electronic energy will surge through him as he takes a second wind here.
Second wind. All right. Get a little bit of health there. That ends your turn, Captain. Stomp it.
Aye. Hold up me shield. Stabilize me. Shot. And I'm going to take two shots at it right in the wings.
Go for it.
That'd be a 14.
That'll hit. Oh, and that'll miss.
I use a point of luck to reroll that one.
Luck! And that'll hit.
That'll hit. Alright.
The Wyvern sitting there trying to fight at the captain, get into him a little bit, and then the pepper block goes off. It rings across the ocean, heard for miles away as the pepper box goes off, just smashing into this Wyvern.
19 points of damage total as I try and draw a parrot in its skin.
Ah. Have a little bit of fun. Bit of fun with the peppering. All right, Stompy, I think that ends your turn. Yar, you are grappled and restrained by the shark. What are you doing?
How does the shark feel like he's doing?
He's got a pretty good grip on you.
You feel like he's doing pretty lively.
I mean, you hit him pretty hard. He is not technically bloodied yet.
Okay. All right. Well, then we are going to sword burst in its mouth.
Ooh.
So what does that mean?
A deck save.
What does this look like, James?
Basically, I just flex as much as I can while I'm inside of his teeth, and battle axes start spinning around me. Just ethereal, shining battle axes.
Love
it. Start to batter more at his dental work.
All right. He rolled a natural 6, and that's a 6 total, so.
Nice. He takes 9 points of damage.
9 points of damage.
And then a bonus action, I'm going to second wind.
Second wind.
I'm hurt a lot. Yar, do I see anybody? Like, can I see anything, or am I just in his mouth?
You were like in his mouth.
And we're just going straight down.
Yeah.
To the depths. Well, at least I can breathe. Is it beautiful? Are there any other fish?
I mean,
sharks.
For sure. I mean, it's a little clouded because there's so much blood coming from you. But outside of that, like being this deep under the ocean, you can feel the pressure on you, and it's like popping in your ears, you know. But like outside of that, like it's just this vast blue death coming for you out of here. That'll end your turn. That brings you around to the shark. The shark will. And try and chomp and consume you completely if it can.
That's rude.
It's still under that effect, so it can only do the. It can only attack you. It can't keep swimming with you. Mm-hmm. So first.
Swim.
First attack. Oh, I did that wrong. Hold on. Is going to be a 23.
It hits.
And second attack is going to be a 19.
Does not hit.
Oof. Lame. That's going to be 19 points of piercing damage as he continues to smash into you and bite you.
Arr!
He would keep swimming down further, but unfortunately, he can't do that.
He's also playing his migraine.
Patches.
I'll show you the second reason they call me Patches. And he rips his shirt off.
In the water.
I no one wants to see that.
Yeah, it's wider on top and I'm below. I use Zephyr Strike. I roll with advantage on one of my attacks.
Zephyr Strike.
I'll save you, laddie. You just hold tight.
I'm pretty tight up in here.
A 19.
19 hits.
And a 20.
Both of those hit, no problem. Roll damage on that.
Roll advantage on one, by the way.
Okay.
Patches only did 12 damage. But due to my Zephyr Strike, his fins burst out and his scarred chest shows from. He points out, even though there's nobody in range, he's like, this scar right here is from the last wrestle I had with a shark. And he moves 60 feet towards him.
You're getting a lot. Definitely getting. You're probably almost there now. You're probably within 10 or 15 feet.
I'm coming down for you, mate.
Iveria.
Nope. Okay. How's this wyvern looking?
Rough.
Okay. I'm gonna move 5, 10, 15, 20, 24, 30. Still too far away. That's fine. Okay. Iveria, she is going to, she's just kind of tilt her head a little bit, put her fingers, her two fingers on her chin, looking at the wyvern, and she'll go, darling, didn't you learn from your friend? You don't have a place here on this ship. And she will just kind of, like, bring her hands together and, like, release them very quickly, and you'll see this big blinding flash of light streak out towards the creature, and it will hit it, and it, well, we'll see if it hits it, and then we'll narrate some more. That is going to be 9. That probably doesn't hit.
9 plus what?
No, that is my plus.
Oh no!
That is with my plus. Yeah,
that'll miss.
And she'll just kind of frown as it misses, but she'll look at the captain and she'll inspire the captain.
It just so this beam of energy just goes wide. And then you do what?
I will inspire the captain and I will sing. Oh, we'd be all right in the winds in ourselves. Oh, we'll be all right if the winds in ourselves. Oh, we'd be all right if the winds in ourselves. And we'll all hang on behind. And we'll roll the old chariot along. We'll roll the old chariot along.
But we're on a boat!
We're on a boat! I'm on a boat!
I am not on a boat.
Well, that'll end your turn, Iberia. The wyvern. I guess I'll just come at the captain because he's at this point kind of desperate. So to captain, first attack, that's a 21.
Yes.
Second attack, that is a 17.
17 will miss.
17 misses. So the bite comes at you and this time it pulls the shield away and then bites at you. That will be a total of 8 damage.
Have to four.
Yard.
And then that will end the wyvern's turn. Theodore.
He bites like a chihuahua.
All right. Theodore continues swimming down. Can you get in the range of the shark now?
Or sure.
Fantastic. Okay.
Because he couldn't move last time, so yeah.
Yeah, so he's just kind of sitting there, swimming in circles, twiddling his fins like the little guppy he is.
Mount him!
You know, I think he might. Theodore, as he approaches the shark, he's going to draw two rapiers from his belt, and he is going to attempt to stab them into the top of the shark and mount him and ride him into the depths.
Go for it. Roll a hit.
All right. Oh, that's not good. Okay.
The first one, you try to stab in, but you don't. Ow, you realize, like, you would expect the skin to be more like sandpaper, but it's kind of slick, and your rapier goes flying off. Second one.
That's all right. Yeah. Second attack. Oh. That's more like it. Okay. That's gonna be that's a 19 plus 6, and can I attach Booming Blade to that?
Booming Blade is like a cantrip. You only get one attack with it. So, no.
Not neat.
Does that make sense?
Wait, why not?
It's a spell attack.
Because you make a spell attack, not an attack roll. Does that make sense?
Oh, so I can't Booming Blade through my swords?
You can make your first attack a Booming Blade, but then you don't get your second attack.
Oh, I got you. Yeah, because it's an action. Okay, I see.
Yeah.
You know what? That's okay. Yeah, we're going to do that and drive the second sword deep into his sharky flesh. You roll this damage. That is 9 points of damage.
9 points of damage to the shark. The shark is having a rough go of things. Having a tough time.
Does he look rough?
Yes.
Action surge?
Ooh! An action surge. Go for it.
Oh, we going in, baby. Let's do it. Alright. 2 more attacks coming at this shark.
Mm-hmm. You can now Booming Blade if you want to do 1 attack.
Okay, yes, I would like to Booming Blade.
Okay. So now it's just 1 attack. It does hit. Roll damage on it.
13 plus 6, fantastic. Okay.
So the first attack, the rapier goes off to the side, the second one sticks in, and you're just like, I can do this. You pull up, and this one starts to radiate with energy as you come down onto it.
That's 11 points of damage.
11 points of damage. And the shark begins to glow with this kind of the tattoo like energy that came off of our dear Theodore has now kind of imprinted itself onto the shark, and it starts to kind of pulse with this glyph of warding type of energy as it goes
around. Where I sliced them, it's like as the blood spews out, the energy kind of sits in the gash that I left him.
Wait. Perfect. Waiting. Top of the round. Cotton.
How far away is this wyvern from me?
This wyvern is about 10 or 15 feet from you, and it looks like it's about to run away.
This jerk.
Yeah, but it's looking rough.
Averia, ship is yours. I'm gonna go kill that shark.
Of course it is, darling.
That's what it means. Wyvern won't touch me.
Just wink.
As Captain Gruul runs to the bow in a maneuver he's done too many times, grabs an anchor, wraps it around.
Does a 20 hit?
Yeah, it does.
Make a constitution saving throw. As you move away, the tail comes out and gets you.
With advantage, yes. Because things...
Sure.
You're not mean at me.
You take 12 points of piercing damage, and that's a terrible roll.
That is awful.
And 8 points of poison damage.
Oh, wow, look at that. Look at all those ones.
That's a bunch of ones.
Nice.
I have 4 ones, a 6, a 3, and a 4. Rough.
So if I did that right, that's 6 damage total.
I think so, yeah.
Okay. Doesn't even notice. And I will
action. No, it should be, so because it's 12 and halved to 8, halved to 4, so 16, the uncanny dodge, 8 damage. Because you're resistant to poison, right?
Yes.
Yeah, 8 damage.
Patches gets ready to score.
Bonus action dash, so we'll get 60 feet of movement, and I'll get like over here probably.
Okay.
Grab that anchor, wrap it around myself, draw my sword.
See you on the other side.
And he just flings himself off of the ship with this anchor. See, the thing is, he's made half of iron and half of lead. So he sinks like a rock. The anchor's to keep him up.
The anchor's a rope in this situation. And so you just start like a meteor down into this water. And you begin falling. And that will end your turn.
I just held up six fingers. I'd give you 10, but I lost 4.
Stompe. Captain has abandoned you with his wyvern. What are you doing?
Frank, give me a stencil to draw you on this wyvern. And Crank is going to fly at the wyvern and make his own attack.
Ooh. Crank comes up.
I see a 13.
13 hits exactly.
Oh, yes.
Nice.
Take his eye! Take his eye!
That be 9 points of damage.
9 points of damage. Perfect.
And then, as Crank rests upon the wyvern's skin, I'm going to pull the pepper box out and drive it through its hide.
I love it. Go for it.
Another 14.
That hits. Oh, this is going to be amazing.
And use another luck point.
Another luck! And that hits too!
23!
Oh, the luck on this wyvern! So the Crank has come up and is like kind of like posed and started biting at the wyvern and then smashing this thing into further. How much damage do we get?
For 21 more points of damage.
And describe this for us if the wyvern dies with this. How do you want to do this?
I pepper him with the pepper box, walk up to him, and make sure I pull the hide off, hold it up, and it's perfectly in the shape of Crank. And I rest it upon my shield.
So this like piece, it's like pop, 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 like all the way around, and pulling off this wyvern scale hide piece comes up, and it looks very similar to Crank. You know what? Make a performance check. Let's see how well did you do.
Yeah.
Interesting.
Oh no.
This be a first for Iron Mallor. Appy a 7.
Iberia, you look over and Stumpy's got the wyvern hide pulled up. The creature lays dead, bleeding all across the deck. And he holds it up. He's like, "Does it look like Crank?" And like it kind of looks a little bit like it. Like it's a vaguely bird shaped. That's about it.
Of course, seeing him take out this wyvern, Iveria will raise her sword and she'll go, "Huzzah! There's some! I support you completely!"
Huzzah!
Huzzah!
Yar.
All right, perfect. Well done. Well done, Stumpy. Yar, you're in the mouth of this shark again. What do you do?
I'm going to communicate with the shark.
Okay.
I'm just going to talk to him.
But hey, what's up?
Bro. We could have been friends. We could have had a great time. We had to go and drag me down.
Drag me down. Sleep on him. Sleep. Okay. Roll it. Lullaby for the shark. What level sleep do you do?
The only level I have, 1.
First level sleep. I don't know if you can do it. Sleep. It's gonna be close.
Did it send through?
I don't see it. What'd you roll?
I don't know. It didn't send through on my end either.
Oh no!
Can you just roll it on D8?
You want me to roll them?
Yeah, roll 5d8 for me.
On it.
Captain.
Not the worst roll, not the best roll. 21?
21 is just short. So you start singing the lullaby to this shark, and like you see his eyes start to go
down.
His eyes start to go a little dark, like he's tired of all this, but not today. He just grips a little bit tighter. That's your action. Bonus action?
Bonus action? Oh, no. No.
No.
No. And bonus action, Yar.
Yar!
Yar.
Two attacks coming at you. He's going to kill one person.
Yar.
Not today.
Probably not today, because a 19 misses, yeah?
Yeah.
And natural 20. Maybe he can do it.
He's going to do it. That's for sure.
Oh, Yar, no. You should have took that luck point, man.
That is 47 points of damage.
Oh, my goner.
And so with that, he's trying to, Yar is trying to put the shark to sleep. And like with that, he just rips him open. You see part of his arm starts to like kind of float there and dangles, like it's dripping away. And the shark begins to like throws his body out, and his body starts to sink. Because you're wearing armor, right?
Yeah.
Starts to sink further down, unconscious. Patches.
Me mate, I was just short. How far away is this ye bastard?
From you now, with what you've had, probably like 20 feet.
Is it an acrobatics check to grapple?
It's an athletics check.
He's legit gonna grapple the shark.
Yeah, shark grapple.
I can't not all try right. Make all grandma right. Say I'm not very athletic, but but I'll be damned if I don't try.
Go for it.
I attempt to grapple him.
Make an athletics check.
You got kill this, Patchy. Now.
Oh no! It's a 10!
That's a 20 on his side. You try to grapple, use your action, you try to grapple it, he just, the tail smacks into you.
Ah! I'll be back next round though, you best believe. But not before I send a farewell gift and I shoot him with a crossbow handgun.
Okay, sure.
It's a 25 to hit.
That hits no problem. Roll that damage.
9 damage he takes.
He's so close. Well, not that close, but he's getting down there. Iberia, you and Stumpy are on the roof of this, on the deck of this boat. You can't see anything down there. What are you doing?
Well, if I jump off this side of the, or the starboard side of the ship, will I be able to get a clear shot at this massive gargantuan creature?
They're pretty far down. They're like 70 feet down.
But if, would I be 120 feet within range if I jumped off the side of the ship?
Probably, yeah.
Okay. Iveria is going to finish
you'll,
her...
Well, you'll have, to, you'll have to use your action to dash to get off. The boat.
Oh, so I wouldn't... And I can't see how the shark's doing, right?
No.
That's fine. I'm going to do it anyways. Okay, Iveri is going to, like, holster her sword back in, and she'll be like, I'll be seeing you in the water, Stump. You can handle things from here. And she will, like, run, jump, and then free fall, swan dive into the water. And she will begin swimming towards the shark and just, with the grace of a trident.
Perfect.
Yeah.
You are on your way. Theodore!
On my way.
Yo, this shark picked the wrong ship to roll up on, bruh.
He did.
He jumped in the water after the shark. So, Theodore, in melee with this hideous beast, he is going to just continue to slash at it with his two rapiers.
Go for it.
Yeah.
This might end it.
All right. First, okay. So, I got to use the booming blade with my action, right?
Yes.
Okay. So he's gonna do that.
All right. Roll ahead.
The sword lights up with the thunder energy, and ooh, that's gonna be close.
Actually, so when he killed Yar, he would have turned and swam towards you. So he would have closed that gap. So go ahead and roll Booming Blade damage for him moving last time, too.
With pleasure.
Yeah, because he doesn't know what Booming...
Right?
This shark doesn't know what Booming Blade is.
Yeah, that's an extra 2d8. Okay, cool.
Yeah, give me that damage.
That's 11 points of damage.
11 points. All right, so 8 plus something probably hits as well. Go ahead and roll that damage on this Booming Blade, too.
Fantastic. Okay.
I think you know what? Yeah, go ahead and roll it real quick because I think this is it.
Fourteen points of damage.
How do you want to do this, Brandon?
Oh yeah. Seeing pieces of his shipmate floating in the water. The cloud of red, smoky blood. It invigorates Theodore, and he says, "For Yarg!" And he takes the sword, lighting up with the thunderous energy, and he just slides it across the side of the shark, like cutting into its gills and its flesh, and just peeling off all of its scales. And the booming blade energy kind of seeps into the gash, and he just brings it all the way down the side of the shark and just leaves it sitting there, floating in the water, lifeless.
It kind of turns up, belly up, and starts to float and rise towards the top. And with that, well done. You at some point, the captain and I'm sure Iveria start moving towards our dear Yar, who's sinking. Is this a competition to do what?
I'm sinking faster.
You're sinking quick. That's true.
Misses.
Yeah, and you're tied to it. I don't even think you could get there. You just keep going.
He just keeps like sinking down into the chain,
hoping someone starts coming back up.
So with that, I would say Iveria gets over there. They get Yar. You guys get some healing into him. We know you do your pirate thing and get him back on deck. Everyone makes
the chain of the anchor.
And you guys are probably able to do all that before Captain's able to get back on deck. So you're all on top of the boat, on the deck of the boat now. As Captain, as you climb back up the chain and make your way onto the deck of the boat, and you can see the entire squad there, your entire crew, on the deck of the boat heading towards Sunspell. What do you guys do?
Arr, that Thor was a good fight, laddies. Only one of us got mostly eaten.
Are all of my limbs
victory is had, gents. Strike the colors.
Arr.
I don't know what that means, but
patch
Arr.
Wyvern onto our patch flag.
Well done.
Someone drew a really nice pleasure. Picture over here.
It's just a flag with like different patches of things we've destroyed on it.
Oh, Stump, that's a nice dog you carved out.
Yeah, it looks good.
Take the head and mount it on the front of the ship to intimidate the other wyverns.
Stumpy, can we eat this darn wyvern?
Captain, you don't eat.
You're right, but I like to try.
All right.
I like the way it drips down me armor.
Stumpy turning down a meal? That's once in a lifetime right there.
Oh, the wyvern be all mine. It'll be done by sundown.
Is it time for my motivational speech? Iberia climbs the mast of the ship. She wipes the blood from her face. Pulls out her sword and she goes, "Lads, lasses, we've been betrayed. We here have a letter of mark from Sunspell to our captain. He breaks the oaths of our crew, the oaths of our family. He breaks the oath of no prey, no pay. Seems his family is the nation of Sunspell now. We've all seen it. The captain takes himself ashore to crack old Jenny's teacup. He thinks of himself and himself alone. How often have we seen him two sheets to the wind, lads? He's crimped us for far too long while we carry the very wind in these sails. I think it's time for him to dance the hempen jig. Who's with me?
Aye! Go pose in front of ye mirror and get ye some deaf-kneed dung munchkin crap sock.
What he said?
This horror sounds like mutiny.
Mutiny.
You know why they call me Gruel, boys? Because it rhymes with cruel, and the lash comes out again.
Well, sounds like we will settle this in...
Mutiny must be solved by force of violence.
Boys, we gotta wager overboard. Ye.
There's only one way off of this ship.
Our shun spell. Oh, no. Ye take your mutinous selves and ye sign up. Everyone that's loyal to me, you sign up too. And we'll deal in blood for the entertainment of the audience. Losers has to join the other's crew and gets the loot from winning.
Yeah.
I heard loot, you got yourself a deal, that's for sure.
Yar.
They're eyeballing with it.
I'll bet me Riot Ruby for it as he literally reaches into his skull and pulls out the ocular focus for his right eye.
We accept Iveria, yes? I need that eye.
The eye will be yours, my friend.
I have one more condition, Captain. I need your shirt, too.
My
ripped mine up.
Iveria begins to take her. I'm just kidding.
Oh, lady, ma'am, no.
Inspiration be mine.
Men's size only.
All right, so that so we will settle this mutiny in Iron Valor fashion here to the next day. So all of you can go ahead and take your long rest as we get ready to head into this next phase of the battle. So thank you everyone who has given their coins to their players. You can go if you need to or want to, or you still have some left. Go ahead and redeem your. Redeem your favorite and champion and show them some love, give them some coins as we go into this final this auction phase. So available for tonight's session is going to be a javelin of lightning, a great sword of sharpness, potion of fire breath, some mariner's armor, and then a ring of protection. And so during our break, our players will go ahead and bid on those items, the ones that they need for this PvP phase as we head into Team Red and Team Blue. Is there anything I missed?
I'm actually going to go ahead and I'm going to initiate the Iron Valor t-shirt giveaway if you will pop that up on screen, Daniel.
Yes.
So you can see it.
You can win this wonderful Tail Weaver shirt. That's available for anyone who is, you must be following. And you're going to put in the command, once Lauren starts it, you're going to use the command loot. That's L-O-O-T, command loot to enter the giveaway. And at the end of phase three, we will give that away to one lucky follower. So go ahead and as we do this, and so stick around with us. We'll be about 10, maybe 15 minutes as we tally up all of the gold pieces and give our auction pieces and go from there. So we will be right back. And we're back. Thank you everyone for sticking with us through the break. We are happy to announce that our most valuable adventurer in phase one is our guest player, Lauren. As our dear, showing out as Miss Iveria Reefborn with 600 gold pieces on her own. Team Mutiny over here actually did very, very well with Lauren, okay. Jesse, and Dylan all scoring in the top half of this Iron Valor. So congratulations to them. Blue Team, not so much. However, in the auction, it was revealed through some clever betting that Team Red won the Javelin of Lightning and the Great Sword of Sharpness. Who got those on Team Red? Who's holding on to those?
Stumpy got ye sword.
I take the magical javelin of sorcery.
And then Team Blue got the great ring of protection, the potion of fire breath, and the mariner's armor. Who's holding on to those guys?
This here is your captain speaking. He can float now.
He's buoyant.
Are you taking that ring?
Extra buoyant.
Yeah, Theodore's got a shiny new ring on his finger.
And now Yar can blow dragon breath.
Blow fire, Yars.
Yar.
Yar. Yar.
Just yar, yar, yar.
All right.
Also, one of you gets a healing potion. I'm not sure which one.
And people have healing potions and stuff. So, going into this final round, and as we end into phase three, your contributions matter even more than before. So, as you remember, you can now redeem red or redeem blue. I think those are the commands, right? Command.
Yeah, so you can redeem luck, blessings, and curses. It would be command, redeem. And then if you're doing luck, it would be luck, red. But no space in between luck and red. Or if you're redeeming a curse, it would be command, redeem, curse, red. But no spaces in between. And the same thing goes for blessings. You would do command, redeem, and then bless, blue.
So the command is bless,
but no red. Spaces, yeah, no spaces space. In between. No spaces in between, like, bless and the color of the team. That
so it'd be, like, so bless, red, or curse, blue. However you want to do it, or vice versa, you know, that's fine.
If you need a reference, there's a panel on our About tab. There's a panel just for our commands. You can always look at the panel and, like, reference how much things cost and what the command is. Mm-hmm. That's why that's there, because it's really easy to get it mixed up of what goes where when you're redeeming.
So. Now that we have that, those are really going to change the tide of this battle. So as we go into it, keep that in mind. So stick around, and we will select a winner of the giveaway at the end of this phase three. So,
blood gods are smiling upon Team Red. Heloidy and Dappergent 13 both bestowed a blessing on Team Red.
Okay.
Wow.
So starting out with. All the blessings. Let's go ahead and deal that since we're already here. So with that, I'm going to roll on the blessings table for Dappergent, which is a natural one, which is everyone on Team Red will receive additional hit points and to their maximum. You all receive 6 additional hit points.
Nice.
On top of everything. And then for Heloides' blessing to Team Red, another one. And so you guys will receive yet another 10 points. So you're going to go into this thing up 16 points max.
Nice.
The blood gods reign supreme. So as we begin this journey into the Iron Valor, you find yourselves in the familiar locker room beneath the arena, and the sun has set, the lights have come out, the people are in the stands, and they are hammered drunk, ready to see some of these pirates deal it out. There's some bad blood in this particular arena, and the door opens up, and there's this wave of air that comes rushing towards you. It's splitting the water itself as you rise up through this kind of like Moses parting the Red Sea situation, and you enter up into the arena and find yourselves on opposite boats. The arena has been filled with water that you can see within. There are hunter sharks swirling, waiting for anyone who should be so foolish as to enter their domain. You look around and see all the crowd is growing crazy and jumping, and they're excited to see this beautiful fight between the murderous, mutinous first mate and the captain and his crew. And with that, we will roll initiative.
Let's go.
That's rough for me.
I've rough. Never rolled good in me life.
Oh, perfect. Nice. Nice stump.
All right.
I'm faster than you think.
Okay, not terrible.
Big as a barn, fast as a fox he is.
Okay, how's about nice?
That's not terrible either.
All right, 25 to 20.
20.
Ooh.
Ooh, 20. Re-roll, both of you.
3. I rolled a 22.
Okay. I rolled a 2.
You got this!
Captain with a... Oh, you rolled one as well?
Rolled a six.
You won there!
Captain be first.
Captain first, and then followed by... I think Yar.
Jesse.
Good rolls, Captain.
Jesse followed by Yar.
Yeah.
Jesse, and then... So, that will be Stump.
Stump.
And then Yar.
Sandwich.
All right, 15.
I unhinged my legs as we entered, so I'm blurring around.
Blur. 15 to 20. Oh no, 10 to 15.
13 for Theodore.
12.
Theodore.
He also comes in looking a bit blurry himself.
Theodore and Patches. And then what are you rolling up with, Iberia?
Three.
Yeah. Yeah, there we go. Iberia with the three. Alrighty.
Pulling up the caboose just like last time.
Captain, you look around and you can see
that. Somebody's gotta watch your ass.
You come around the top, Captain, you can see you guys can place yourselves wherever on these boats you choose to be. The boats themselves have little their walls come up about 3 feet. They're considered half cover. And then the sails on both ships have these ropes that swing back and forth. The distance between the two boats is about 15 to 10 feet. So it'd be hard to jump, but it can be done. Top of the round, Captain, you look around, you see these sharks. They look ravenous in the water around you. Your initiative. Go first.
Yar, so where be these swinging ropes?
Hanging from the mast that you can see right here.
Hmm. And what be the techie jargon for swinging between these har boats?
Arr, you're a pirate. You can just do it. Arr.
I'm coming for ye, Iberia, ye lion.
So No, he's not going to say it. She's just a lion.
She's just a lion.
Pirates are proficient in rope swinging, so you just...
Lauren, you didn't move yourself. Did you want to be where you were?
Oh, no, I don't.
Move yourself wherever you want.
I probably want to be... Actually, I don't know. Behind. That's fine. Sure. I'm good where I am.
Captain, what are you doing?
I'm swinging a arse.
All right, 5, 10 feet.
Land my 600-pound lead arse right on top of her head.
You swing over, and it'll take your full movement to get there, but you land on the deck just like... Ready to fight, like
straight
Edward Kenway.
He goes straight through the boat.
That would be crazy, but he does not.
So where do I end up?
You're gonna end up right here with all your movement gone.
Right here?
No, right there. Stumpy, as he's coming and landing next to you, he can't really defend himself. If you want to, you can take an opportunity attack as he swings across.
That be a 26 to hit.
That be a hit.
So the captain comes swinging across, bionicle nature, and as he does, Stumpy.
Takes 7 points of damage from the pepper box.
All right.
That ain't even worth uncanny dodging, you fool.
Sure.
Oh, just wait.
All right, so you land there. You're right there within Iberia and Stumpy's range.
And... Sword in hand, I will cast a spell, obviously. Oh crap, let's not do that. Don't close out your characters, kids. It prevents you from looking at things.
True.
True.
Technology be a wild thing.
Kinda.
Arr.
Yarg.
I'm gonna cast create bonfire right underneath Patches.
I've seen this one. He did this to our own ship one time.
The ship, the bonfire explodes right underneath. I don't know. Are there rules for that? I don't know.
Yes, there are.
What happens?
God.
Deck save.
It's hot.
Deck save, Stumpy. As the ship itself starts to catch fire, and you do as well, and it starts to go crazy.
There not be a fire under Stumpy, right? It's under Patches.
Oh, do you say Patches? Or did you say Stumpy?
Yeah, Stumpy.
on a stumpy.
Unfortunate.
Oh no.
Unfortunate.
That save. He just like drips gunpowder on top of you, and as he lands, like he clicks his heels and it catches on fire.
That'd be a 14.
That will pass.
Oh yes.
That is the same.
Stumpy be a dancer, eh? Level
7. Your boat begins to catch fire as you just scooch your way out. Bonus action.
I believe I can take dodge here. I'm not absolutely positive, but I think I can.
Okay, if you can, you can. If you can't, you can't. That ends your turn. Stump. You dance out of the bonfire. What do you do?
Hey, Crank gonna be sent to fly over towards Mr. Sachs over there.
Oh, bring it on.
He's going to take the help action to cancel out any disadvantage Stumpy may get, and is going to take two shots at the...
At Sachs.
At the what?
At Theodore.
Theodore. All right. And that's with half cover for you, Sax.
That'd be a 28 on a natural 28.
Ooh.
Step one, get natural. Step one, get natural 20.
Can I use my luck point for that?
You can. You can make him re-roll it.
Oh yeah, you're definitely re-rolling.
Oh!
Another one! Another one!
And this is the blood god strike, right?
That'd be a 12.
Yeah. That be a miss.
I
just why?
Second attack on Theodore. Oh, that be another 12. I gotta use my luck points as well.
Another more lucks.
Bring it.
That be a 16 to hit.
16 does not hit. He moves his head and dodges the out of the way of the pepper box. Is that all you got, mate?
The pepper box
it seems to be.
The pepper box is going off, pop, 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 but Sax just ducks down and it's just peppering the boat itself, and none of the bullets getting through. Bonus action.
My bonus action was Crank's help.
Oh yes, so movement. No movement.
Run, there ye coward.
Captain, why I run from ye?
Ooh.
You can't run. You have two peg legs.
You could just waddle.
Quick to judge a book by its cover, eh? That's why you're not captain anymore.
You missed the barn with a bonfire. Just putting it out there.
Yar.
You got him good, Stumpy. You got him good.
Yar, your turn.
How is it just movement to swing across?
It takes your full movement. You can get there and you can swing across if you want to.
So would I be able to hold onto the rope, swing across, and then come back if I didn't let go?
Ooh.
You could do that, but I don't think you could hit anyone.
Well, I don't need to hit anyone.
Yeah, I'd say you could do that. Cool. You're proficient in rope swinging.
So I'm going to swing across, and as I'm just near the ship, I'll drop an echo on it.
Okay, so you got one hand on the rope and you jump and you swing, like do that thing where you swing all the way around, almost come into distance with everyone, and then drop in your
Yar Junior.
Just tosses a baby on the boat.
Just blip.
Oh man. That was not good. I think that's right. Okay. Yar Jr., and where does it appear?
Put it right there below the captain. And
below the captain.
I will have it go up to Iveria.
Okay.
And I still have my action, correct?
You know what? I'm gonna say have it doing all of that and coming back across. That's gonna eat your action. That's a lot of work and a lot of time to swing all the way across, drop an echo, and come all the way back.
Because the echo's the bonus action.
Yeah. So okay. Because you're swinging there and then you're swinging back. So
then he will not approach Iveri. He will stay at the helm of the ship.
And so you swing back, Yar, and like over there, now you have an echo on that side, and you're back over here. Now there are two Yars. And
two Yars, one for each ship.
One for each ship. And that ends your turn.
Hello, Sax, I'm back. I learned my lesson.
Perfect.
Yeah.
Theodore.
Always get back on the boat, bro.
Always get back on the boat. Okay.
Theodore.
All right. So, looking at this mechanical bird over here flying over my head, trying to make things difficult, then I'm going to take a look over at Stump and just crack a little smile. His tattoo is going to start crackling with electrical yellow and blue energy, and he's going to whip his hand over towards Stump and cast Lightning Lure. And he's going to use a... Where is it at? He's going to use one of his sorcery points and cast it as a distance spell, which doubles the range of it. And he's going to attempt to lasso Stump and then pull him 10 feet into the water with the sharks.
I love it. Theodore, you swing across, make an attack roll.
Oh, it's a save.
It's a save? Make a save, Stumpy.
What's the save?
I would like to counterspell that.
Ooh. Counterspell.
Okay.
What does this look like?
What does the counterspell look like?
Yeah. What does Iveria's counterspell look like?
Iveria looks up and she says, "What a little grog blossom you are."
Grog blossom.
"Perhaps the taste of my cutlass will sober you up for a fair fight. No lightning today for you, love." And she will just kind of like rear her arms up a little bit, and like this force energy will just kind of like make her head just her hair fly up, and she will just kind of like wink and snap her fingers.
And it just, the lightning as it's coming across just fades.
Mm. Oh, got him good, Captain.
You
got
see
him good.
Stumpy as he holds his finger up to his mouth like, "You coming?"
Oh no.
I would expect nothing less of these cheap tricks from you traitorous dogs.
Not bad. Counterspell and a cantrip.
Counterspell the cantrip,
yeah.
Hey, it was gonna be rough. It's not good to get in that water, I promise. Alright, that's action. You can move and get a bonus action left. Our dear Theodore.
Let me see. I'm gonna stay where I am for now. Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, I'm gonna stay where I am for now.
All right, perfect. That'll end your turn. That brings us around to Patches.
Oh, Patches it is! I pull out my crossbow. Bringing children into a fight among men is pitiful, to say the least. And I mark Yar as my target.
Yar.
Which one?
The non-child, of course, you menace.
Oh, okay. Did you say something about cover on this side?
It's a half cover.
Nice.
Half cover.
Shots, cover, be damned.
I don't know, is Patches sharpshooter?
Patches is not sharpshooter.
It's unusual.
What? Not a sharpshooter?
Slow expert.
It's like Dylan made a character not sharpshooter.
I know, right? What?
Surprising.
Roll to hit. Half cover plus two.
The hit I will. A 20.
No.
Oh.
Wow. Okay.
Oh, no, that one doesn't hit either.
Two misses. One goes wide and up and it goes into the crowd, dissipates as it hits the exterior arena force field. The other one, ding, into the stump. Right there in front of the boat. That's two attacks. Bonus action?
I already used it to mark him.
Oh, he's already marked, yeah. That injured turn, then it passes unless you want to move.
Do I have to move to the rope to swing?
You have to move to the rope to swing to it.
Can I do it?
Yeah. You know, you can run over there, you can swing, and then get on the other side. No problem. Okay, so as you do, you swing across. You're going to provoke opportunity attacks from the captain and Theodore as you swing across. But you don't have to take it.
Oh, yeah.
Oof. My astral's lagging.
Against who?
Captain, if you want to take an opportunity attack, you may, and so may Patches.
Against
Stumpy? Stumpy.
No, against Patches.
Against patches. Yeah. So Theodore can take one and Captain can take one. As he runs across, grabs a rope and swings over the other side, landing on the other boat.
Am I capable of using Booming Blade here?
I don't think
you can.
Action to Booming Blade, but...
I think that's one of those things, like, if you're a war caster, you can. But if you're not, then you can't.
Yeah, because it's
taken. Unless I'm mistaken. Because yeah. you have to make a spell attack, you know, in order to, as an opportunity attack, so.
Well, it says a melee attack. It says, as a part of the action used to cast the spell, you must
make
a melee
attack. Yeah, you're right.
But that's part of the action to cast the
spell. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You make a melee attack. It's not part of the attack action that you cast the spell.
Yeah, it's the opposite way around, so no, you can't. But you can just hit him with regular stuff. You can get sneak attack, obviously.
Yup.
Yup.
I think that misses.
A 15.
A two will miss. A 15 hits from Theodore.
Yeah. From Theodore. All right.
Yeah. There's a plus
also. Oh yeah. Plus seven. Yeah. So. Yeah. All right. You coming over here on my ship?
I.
Yeah, we call this the welcome wagon.
Oh, no.
Let me roll my damage here. Booyah shaka. That's going to be 10 points of damage.
Aye.
To old Patches here. Another scar for you to tell stories about, if you survive.
But at least you didn't get me eye.
Not yet. At end your turn, Patches, Iveria.
Iveria will look at the sailors across to the other boat, and she'll say, "You look so lovely. Perfect straight line. Let me show you how real lightning is cast." And she will, like envelop her arms around. You'll see her eyes crackle with lightning energy. And you'll see temporary scars appear on her arms, and she will cast a lightning bolt straight down against Captain Gruul and Yar.
Ooh.
That is a deck save. Ooh,
deck save.
I'm really good at this,
Captain Yar.
Look at that! Look how good I am. Oh, I'm magnificent.
That's what I'm talking about.
Nice.
Matrix dodge that boy.
I sneezed.
Game pass.
Does a 13 save, Lauren?
It doesn't. Wait. It does not.
13 fails. Yar. You're going to pass on this one, I think.
Oh, look. Somebody dropped a coin.
I think you're going to save on that one. Go ahead and roll that damage. Half to Yar.
31.
So 31 points of damage to the captain. And then 15 points of damage to Yar.
And then with my bonus action, I will look at... Patches. I'll look at Patches and I will inspire him and I will sing... The captain, he will trim my sails, weigh my boys to Cuba, winging the water over the rails, running down to Cuba. Weigh me boys to Cuba, running down to Cuba. And I'll inspire him.
My Yo. God, I love Cuba.
Man, that brings up so many.
Never been.
That brings up so many Black Flag memories right now. Like,
I couldn't see anything while I was in Cuba, but man, it was great.
Beware, champions. You have angered the blood gods. Haloidi casts a curse on Team Blue.
Team Blue, you've been cursed with a 4, which means that until the end of your next turn, you may not move. Your speed is 0.
Ooh.
Okay.
All right, top of the round. That everyone in the arena, the sharks begin to move and they hit the boat and knock it up in the air, start giving you some anxiety here. And the arena itself is causing damage to all of you. And you all take 8 points of damage across the board. Everybody in the arena takes 8 damage as the sharks move the boats and the crowd is screaming at you to do your thing and to fight and be valorous as you will, and the adrenaline starts pumping and you're getting closer and closer to your end point. Top of the round, Captain, you cannot move.
Have been maintaining concentration. Stump ended his turn in it, so I need him to make another deck save.
Oh, is that like he started his turn and then didn't move out of it? You didn't move, did you?
Killed it on that one.
Happy a 19, Captain.
I'll pass. It's fine. But it's still burning your ship.
Now you do see this bonfire has now started to spread. In fact, Captain, it probably falls into you now as it's starting to spread out, but unfortunately you can't move. And then it's starting to grow out, and the ship probably has 2 more rounds left here. It's going to burn. Yeah, it's a tinderbox of a ship.
Concentration on it, so it's just normal fire at this point.
Sure.
I'll just kind of grin at Stumpy. Heh, 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 heh. Heh, heh, heh. And reach over and grab one of his cannonballs. You know what's coming. And I'm gonna light him up, point blank range.
Deck save, yeah.
Face.
Deck save.
Deck save, Stumpy.
He's so dexterous.
It's almost like the cannonball. He throws it up in the air and elbows it towards you, and the ricochet like explodes with this air energy. It comes flying at you.
Oh, be a 2.
Ooh, a natural 1.
Critical, yeah.
Critical fail. Oof.
Natural 1, double damage.
In our game, but not this one. okay, so first of all, for everyone who's not here, when we play games, I do double
not
damage.
Not against each other.
Yeah, not in this, yeah. But if it were an enemy, then it would be double damage, but it's not. So, because that would be unfair.
Would be unfortunate.
Would be.
Very unfortunate.
Damage.
How much?
15.
15 Stumpy damage as it goes straight into you. And you don't have any movement? Bonus action.
Bonus action, I'll just kind of put my hand up and re-infuse myself with that energy. Frickin' lightning.
You take 5 points of fire energy or fire damage as the flames have spread onto you now, and you're going to end your turn inside the flames. That ends your turn, Captain Stumpy. You are also in the flames, but you have the opportunity to get out if you want.
I'll move out of the flames.
Out of the flames. So you can, if you want to, yeah, you can back up, and it's about a 10 to 15 foot radius, and it's growing fast.
I move towards the ropes.
Okay.
As it be. crank be annoying Theodore as he always does.
As he always
pecking
does.
At his shoulders, and I will make some attacks. Again, once again, it's him.
Okay. I'm still half cover, right?
You still have cover, yeah. Yar! Yar still have cover! Cover! Yar!
That'd be a 27 to hit.
Yar!
Yar! Yar. Huzzah!
27 will hit. Second attack.
Yeah, that's gonna hit.
Be for 9 points of piercing damage.
9 points piercing, gotcha. Alright.
Oh no, that'd be a 13 to hit.
13, not even close.
A 13 goes wide. So first attack into our dear Theodore. Spins him across. Second one goes right over his shoulder and back into the crowd.
As I hit him, you hear Stumpy yell across the ship, "Have a face full of me booty, ye jellybone thumb-sucking crud git."
Ooh.
Excuse me?
Wow. You kiss your mother with that? Oh, this guy. The insults. The insults. That ends your turn, Stumpy. Yar!
Yar.
Yar. I can't move.
You cannot move.
But it's okay.
Does that apply to his
my echo can move too? Because it doesn't use my movement.
Lovely.
It will approach our
I will say that the blood god power supersedes that.
Really?
Yes.
It supersede
this the blood gods. No movement for the Echo Knight.
Gods really? Be too strong.
The gods have spoken.
All right. Understandable. A little unfair, but understandable.
I'm sorry, it probably is. I'll reevaluate.
The blood gods don't care about
the blood gods don't care about fairness.
I mean, you got patches sitting right here. How about we
show him? I don't even know if I can reach him. He looks a little out of my range.
Didn't get an attack of opportunity, so I take it he's not in range.
Yeah, technically speaking, he landed 10 feet away from you, so no.
Yeah.
You got something with range, like, I don't know, fire breath that you drank already, but...
Oh, yeah. I don't want to hurt my friend, though.
Do it. Set the whole boat on fire.
Yeah, I'm just going to light the boat on fire.
Do it!
Oh, light the boat on fire.
Light the boat on fire.
Wait, I mean, you can hit him. The boat. I think I was.
It's a dex save from Patches and Theodore.
You guys can be fine. You'll be all right.
Yeah. Dex saves from Patches and Theodore as the dragon's breath potion that Yar drank is now gonna fly out towards all of you.
Oh god, it's coming up.
Dex save.
17. It is.
Oh Jesus. Oh, blood gods.
Unfortunate.
Roll that fire damage as the boat also catches on fire. This long 15-foot cone catches the entire boat as it begins to burn as well.
18 damage.
Oh, Jesus.
Oof, that hurt. That's the most.
Top 25 percentile. 18 points to our dear Theodore. I think you save. 17's going to save. You take 9 points of damage there, Patches.
Set your own teammate on fire, will ya? That's what he gets.
That's bonus action for you, Yar, and that'll end your turn.
Yeah, yeah. We're good.
Theodore.
All right.
You're on fire.
Yeah, I'm gonna pet the fire out, you know, real quick.
Knock the burnt hair off.
Yeah. The blood gods. It did be dirty.
But it did. Right. Yeah, you can blame Haloti for that.
Yeah. Fully did be dirty.
Seeing Patches sitting here right in front of me, this traitorous, mutinous dog, Theodore will draw both his weapons and he will lay into Patches.
Aye. Yeah.
Right. He almost didn't see you coming.
First attack.
Good one.
I get it now.
First attack with Booming Blade.
So the one attack with Booming Blade.
Yeah.
Oh!
That's a 14 plus
hits.
Awesome.
Hits.
You go ahead and roll that.
With the booming blade damage, so the tattoo rises up on Theodore's arms. He comes down with the booming blade on top of our dear Patches as he just
slash
landed.
Him across the chest for 11 points of damage.
And then
I not need move.
And then that piece of him just fills up with this little arcane energy where the slash across him was.
Yeah. Then I'm going to use my bonus action and take another attack on him.
You stab him again.
Yeah. Try if you might.
You're on fire.
Arr.
Another hit.
What is that?
Another 14. Another
14.
What's your plus?
Plus 6.
Does not hit.
What?
Me scallywag, I've learned from your cheap tricks. My AC is increased by 4. It's no longer a hit.
Oh, wow. That's...
Oh, that's dope.
Impressive.
It's super cool.
All right, that's fine.
That's action. Most action want to move?
I mean, I do, but I can't, so...
Ah, that's right. True. You can. As
so
you injure...
We'll end my turn there.
You end your turn in the fire, you take 3 fire damage.
All right.
Alright. That ends your turn, Theodore. Patches!
Oi! I now use Hunter's Mark on Yajar! A Yar?
Yar!
Yar!
Yajar!
A Yar!
It's now double marked!
Oh no!
And I'll shoot him twice with me handy dandy crossbow.
Mark me so good that you can actually see the J in my name.
My God, I still can't see him. It's a 13.
You're facing west, so like your left eye is blind. You can't see him over here. Like, he's like over here. He can't see him.
Oh no! It's a 12 this time. he's too hidden.
Too hidden. Arr. Yeah. All right, you're on fire. The ship is on fire. What are you doing? Your camera's gonna trip out on me.
I know. His camera has been like having a stroke this entire.
Killen cast blink on himself.
I mean, yes. It's literally like blinking around.
Both ships on fire. Nowhere safe. I'll darned be opportunity attacks. I'll move out to this fire.
Move out to the fire. That'll opportunity attack from Theodore. And as you do, your booming blade goes off. You take 2d8 damage, which is 8. Did I lose your audio? I did. All right, Theodore, do you want to take that opportunity attack?
Brandon?
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
Otherwise known as Theodore.
Theodore, Brandon.
Ooh, Brandon, Theodore, well, Sachs.
I think a natural one will miss, unfortunately.
I think so, unfortunately. Oh,
I don't know, Dylan, does natural one hit patches?
My God, and I could be completely blind and dodge that, mate. Yeah. It's your own ship, you did.
I love Patches so much. She's my favorite.
Patches is the goat right now. All right, that injured.
He is the goat.
That injured turn, Patches. Iveria.
Okay. Iveria is going to look at her frozen in place foes. They are lined up so very, very nicely once more. She's gonna take her lute from behind her back and just kind of like flip it and grab the handle once more. And lightning will crackle in her eyes again. And she'll say, "Darling, don't hang the jib so easily. Perhaps a tune will help tickle your fancy just a bit." And she will take her lute and like a golf club swing, she will boom. And she will send another lightning bolt to sizzle the flesh off these traitorous, awful sailors.
So that's
I have no flesh.
So Captain and Yar, I need dexterity saves from both of you. Because you can't move, I'm going to give you guys both disadvantage on this save. Because you can't actually get out of there.
Nine
fails. Captain!
That'll fail.
With the fails whale.
A fail as whale.
What fails whale?
26.
Lightning damage to both of you.
How much?
26.
26.
Alrighty.
And I will inspire. I inspired Patches last time. I will now inspire my good boy, my comrade Stump, and I will sing. I thought I heard an old man say, "Whiskey, Johnny, I'll treat my crew in a decent way. Whiskey for my Johnny, yo. A glass of grog for every man. Whiskey, Johnny, and a bottle for the shanty man. Whiskey for my Johnny, yo." And she'll say, "Whiskey for you, lads! Show no mercy!"
I voice of an angel, me captain.
My God. It might even one up an angel if I knew what that was.
Well done.
Blood gods are full of wrath this evening. Dapper Gen 13 cast a curse on Team Blue.
Oh, God.
Y'all, Team Blue is just getting murdered by the curses and everything right now.
Blood gods giveth, the blood gods taketh away.
That's a curse of a 6 to the blood gods. Starting at the top of the round, you could not move before, and it feels like there's some sort of wrath coming into all of you, and your eyes go dark, and you are blind until the end of your next turn.
Oh, lovely.
Jeez.
Awesome.
Top of the round. Everyone, the sharks rage again, almost tipping the boat this time. The fire spreads across both the boats, and the crowd cheers even more for your name. For you to dominate and show your valor and provide a show. The adrenaline pumps. Oh, and you take 3 damage. Everyone across the board.
Oh, no.
You all right over there?
Oh, no, I'm fine.
I rolled a 2 and a 1. Like, lame. Captain, you're blind. Stubby, your turn. What do you do?
We can move now.
I wanted to move. I never got to move. I don't get to move.
You can go ahead and move if you want to.
Sorry. I would like to move out of the fire because the ship is on fire.
Okay, yes.
So we can see.
Is that going to trigger attack from you, Captain?
Nope.
Okay.
Over
here. Captain, what are you doing?
Not much.
At this point, the fire has spread to where it's encompassing nearly the whole front half of this boat and almost the entire back half of the left boat. The sharks swarm in the waters around you. What do you do?
Do I generally know where Stumpy clumped off to?
I mean, you can still hear them. Like, you have a general sense of where they are.
And I'll be a quiet one.
his peg legs squeak as he bounces up and down in the water.
Like, I move forward like a blind person and, like, poke around with my sword until I find him.
Sure.
And then...
I'd be here, Captain.
Right here.
Right here, Captain.
Literally, stab the sword into the deck and try to grab him.
To grapple him?
Yep.
Okay. He's right there. Make an athletics check. Stumpy, athletics or acrobatics, your choice. Boom, boom. Oh.
That'd be an 11.
Got a 14.
10 plus 4. Yeah.
Does this count as a melee attack by any chance?
It is not a melee attack. It is a grapple check.
You have inspiration, by the way.
Oh, I use my inspiration.
Everyone forgets about inspiration.
Yes, yes.
The shanties and the inspiration.
There's a big glowing light on my screen that tells me that I have it, but... what's the inspiration dice that you have right now?
Which is an 8. Should be level 6.
It's a D8.
It's be an 11 plus 3 for 14.
That'll be a tie.
That'll be a tie. Reroll it.
Well, in that case, Stumpy be remembering that the Captain be metal, and his joints not be as quick while they are rusted, and he be using a flash of genius to add a plus 4 to that.
On top of that, so the reaction then a plus 4 will bring us to an even 18 over 14. So that's flash of inspiration and flash of genius, but that will save. Oh, is that there's only saving throws or ability checks too? We did this. It's ability checks.
Ability
too.
Checks or saving.
Yeah, throws. It's both. I remember that because we did the opposite way one time. So he you go up and you grab him, but unfortunately Stumpy's just he's just a little bit too buff. He's got his shield up, and the your metallic arms of this Warforged creature try to wrap around, but you can't get a good grip on him.
Okay. I'll disengage and stump my way over there.
All right, you made it over there. That ends your turn, Stumpy.
Stumpy be swinging over. Torch
Theodore. You run through the fire, and land on the other side where there's also fire. There's Theodore. You roll to hit. if you're doing that. I don't know.
Do you get an attack of opportunity, Theo?
He does. If you still have a reaction.
Yeah, I haven't taken it. I guess that's a disadvantage.
It is with disadvantage.
All right. Theodore just swings wildly, hoping to slice into the first thing that he sees. And yeah, he looks ridiculous.
My God, that was a little bit better than last time, at least.
Better than last time. All right.
That's unfortunate.
Oh, hang on. Patches moved. Didn't the booming blade go off for him? Didn't I hit him the first time?
Already took it.
Yeah, it already went.
Okay. He already took it. Sorry. He got 8 damage. All right, you land there, Theodore. What are you doing?
Stumpy would be landing.
Oh, Stumpy lands here. Yeah.
Bestowing his bird beak shield and his pepper box as for later use, and be pulling out the greatsword that he can barely pick up. It be dragging on the ground.
Ooh, that thing.
One of his peg legs pops, and he uses that action to bring the greatsword out, and uses his own weight to carry it down onto Mr. Sax.
All right, roll the advantage because he's blind.
Yes, well, sir.
I think it's straight roll because he has
blur. Yeah, I've got blur. Oh, I guess I need to make a concentration check for that, though, right?
Yeah, you need a couple concentration checks.
How many do you want me to roll?
Doesn't matter, just the first one.
The first one failed.
So with advantage.
That'd be a 13.
That'd be a miss.
With advantage. Because he's blind.
That'd be a 17.
That'd also be a miss.
Oh, wow. Could also be a miss.
That'd be a luck use for your taunting.
Hmm.
15. Mm. God dang it.
What's the matter there, Stumpy? Can't hit a blind man.
Stumpy pops the other leg and swings again.
Oh, Stumpy.
Stumpy have advantage.
Stumpy
still can't hit.
Oh, Stumpy.
Springs be rusted. Me springs be rusted.
There's something.
I used me oil on the captain. That was a mistake.
You're flying across and landing, like the legs just kind of give out a little bit as there's something mechanically now wrong with the legs. Just didn't work for this. You get it back into place with the oil, quick fix, but that'll end your turn. Oh, Jesus. For Stumpy, yar! Stumpy, you end your turn in fire. You take 4 fire damage, Stumpy.
Oh no.
All right, that brings round 2. Yar!
I'm going to switch places. Because I can tell that there's a lot going on this ship, and I don't see what's happening anymore. The other ship looked a little better from the last time I saw it.
You switch.
All right.
Oh, that's cool.
So does blindness work with the mental moving abilities of my...
He can move now, and you were just right there, so you could move him.
He's going to move up to Stumpy.
All right.
Somebody land in the fire.
Okay.
And I'm going to take my attacks.
Yar, right. Yar.
Yar, yar.
I'm going to yell from the other boat, like, Stumpy, I'm over here.
He be blind, though?
Yeah. Stumpy, I'm over here. Let's see if we can hit anything.
Stumpy be blurred. You have disadvantage.
Okay, so I have disadvantage regardless. Well, the first one definitely doesn't hit.
Yeah. Oh!
So then we'll take the second one. Does an 18 hit?
Our 18 just hits.
Oh!
Just hits. Arr!
Oh, that will be nice. Oh, 1. So 8 points of damage. Yar. I will also let the Echo take its own attack with Unleash Incarnation. He kind of just like takes on actions of his own, and he just reaches out and just hits you.
Okay,
roll it. For no good reason.
With disadvantage again?
With disadvantage. He's blind. And he doesn't hit, unless 12 hits.
12 will miss.
No.
All right.
Definitely not.
He's going to stand there and dance in the fire until he dies.
For sure.
He's not going to last through that fire.
He takes four damage.
He's goner.
He's a goner.
Yar Jr., my son.
Yar Jr.
Son.
My son.
Children die.
Yar, your scurvy infested actions seem
Yar, get out of here.
Have disappointed me as much as you disappoint the women.
Yar.
That ends your turn, Yar. Theodore.
All right, so I am blind. Interesting. can I... Let me see. What can I do? I hear Stumpy talking, using all of this foul language as he insults Theodore and Yar. And so I feel like I kind of have an idea where he is. The boat's on fire, right?
The boat is starting to get on fire. You're currently engulfed in flames. At the start of next turn, it's going to basically encapsulate the whole thing.
Fantastic. I'm going to cast Hold Person on Stumpy over here. I need a wisdom save from you.
Can he do that if he can't see, Captain?
That's what I'm checking.
Oh,
I think you have to be able to see the target.
Is it a target you can see?
It should have said that. Yeah. It says a target you see. Dang it. Okay.
You can hold that spell until the end of your turn, and then you can't see.
Okay, cool. Can I move out of the fire and then hold the spell?
Sure.
All right, yeah. So I'm going to move, like, using the edge of the boat as my guide, like on the rail. I'm going to move back over to here.
As he leaves your range, Stumpy, if you want to take an attack of opportunity, you may.
He can't hit the broad side of a boat.
uno momento, yeah. I forgot to,
He hit it a couple times so far.
Oh!
Oh.
Oh!
What did I say?
No. On the third one, sorry, these were constitution checks. On the third check, my constitution drops.
For the last fire.
The last hit.
So that's good.
Yeah, the last fire at the end of my turn. Okay. Now I need a roll for an attack. Be a 17.
17's not good enough, mate.
You roll with advantage because he's still blind.
Oh, yeah, okay.
19 to hit.
19 to hit? I'm gonna cast shield.
What a cheater!
Yeah. He, the waves themselves kind of splash up over the boat and get in the way of your blade right before they can make contact with Theodore.
That's not how magic works.
Too bad. It stumps.
He's still being in the fire.
All right,
so yeah, I'm gonna move over here. I'm gonna hold my hold person for when I can see him, and mm-hmm. I am going to use my bonus action to second wind.
Bonus action, second wind. You fill up. Your turn ends. Sight comes back to you. You can cast the whole person now if you wish.
Fantastic. Yes, I would. That's a wisdom save.
Arr.
Good at this, right, Stump? You're the wisest man I know.
That not be true.
No.
Aye, that be a 10.
Aye, that be a fail. You, his the tattoos on his arm grow this greenish yellow color as he thrusts his.
Oh wait, Noah, never mind. I'm just kidding.
Oh God.
I'm just kidding.
As he thrust his arm forward, and these tendrils of yellow light just begin to encircle you from your little stumps all the way up to your head, keeping you tightly bound.
And you are
love myself.
And you are held in place, and you are paralyzed for the duration, and may make a save. Yeah, he's currently on fire.
Awesome.
All right, that ends your turn, Theodore. Patches.
Patches cast ensnaring strike. And he attacks Theodore twice.
Ooh. Come at me, mate.
Go for it.
Theodore.
Patches can hit, right?
We'll see.
Maybe.
A 20.
I'm going to cast shield again.
Shield.
A 27!
Holy crap, really?
Shield that.
Shield that, mother...
Wow.
27 hit, I take?
27 definitely hits.
Yeah. Wait. Yeah.
It's like actually nuts.
Take 13 damage and a strength save from him.
And a concentration check for the whole person.
Alright. Let me roll my concentration check first. Ooh. Okay. So concentration drops.
So Stumpy, you feel the tendrils that once held you in place fade.
Oh, actually, well, hang on. I have this I'm favored by the gods, even if it's not the blood gods. Once per short rest, if I fail the saving throw or miss with an attack roll, I can roll. Oh wait. That's what I roll.
A two.
Okay, yeah, never mind. It lets me add a 2d4 to the roll, but I'm not gonna use it on that. I'll save if I fail this next one though, because like you said, I had to make a strength check too, right?
Strength saving throw.
Save. Okay. Does a 10 save?
Does not.
All right, I'm gonna use it on that. I feel like I'm close. Favored by the gods. Let's me roll.
You said it's 2d4.
Yeah.
You automatically pass.
Oh, awesome.
Saves 11.
Was I one off?
You were two off. So even if you roll double one, you got it.
I knew I was close. All right, cool. So concentration drops, but I'm also not ensnared or anything.
You're not ensnared. You take 11 points of damage. Bonus action.
Section was ensnaring strike. What? Both ships on fire, they be. Which ship is more on fire?
They're I would say the right ship is more on fire, but they're all about to be completely doused.
How long till it break?
Probably two more rounds.
Alright, Stumpy, move back to the bow of the ship, away from the fire.
These ships were doused in gasoline before the fight.
My god!
I don't know who made that choice, but here we are.
It was me idea. Thought this might be fun.
You have wooden pegs, you fool! Wooden!
They're metal. I'm not that idiot.
Alright.
Okay.
My turn ends.
End your turn. Alright, Iveria.
Alright, Iveria is going to... She's going to run up to this mast right here, and she's going to pull out her cutlass and cut down the brass bell that is hanged up at the main brace that's used to indicate the regulation of sailor duty watches and swap outs. And she's going to grab it, rip out the part that dings, and just the bell part, and she goes, "It's time for a change of the guard. Only you won't be returning. There's only one room. There's only room for one captain here." And she's going to take her hand and like shove it up against the hole where the ding part was. She's going to use it like a cannon, and she's going to like cannon out a guiding bolt at the captain.
Roll to hit as the radiant energy of Iveria flies.
That is going to be
20 even to hit.
Well, it's with advantage. Well, yeah, 20 even.
Well, he's no longer blind, but 20 even.
20 even.
That'll hit.
The captain engulfs himself in this radiant energy as his first mate and the betrayal that he feels.
No. 20.
Betrayal.
20 damage. Radiant. I think that's radiant damage. Yes.
20 radiant damage to you.
The next attack roll made against the target has advantage. And then I will swing over to the other ship. Can you move me?
Yeah, I moved you.
How'd you move me?
Because you had to go over to the bell thing, which was on the map.
Oh, that was just flavor.
Well, okay, so you run over there, then you fly this way.
Yeah, I was gonna go back to the other ship.
And you swing across.
Yes.
Alright, there you are.
Then I am going to inspire Patches once more.
Oh, I'm already inspired still. But Stumpy.
Oh, that's what I meant, Stumpy, sorry. I'm going to inspire Stumpy. And I'm gonna sing, "Now we're ready to head for the horn. Where roll and go, our boots and our clothes, boys, are all in the pond. To be rollicking dandy, dandy, yo. Heave a pall, oh, heave away. Roll and go, the anchor's on board and the cables are stored. Be rollicking randy, dandy, yo.
Who ain't love a captain that can sing?
I demand the DM also sing.
All right, that ends your turn. Top of the round, everyone is going to take some damage as the sharks are now chomping at the bit over the top of the boat. Iberia specifically, you take 3 fire damage for ending your turn in the fire. Everyone in the arena is going to take 10 points of arena damage. I am rolling terribly.
That's what I'm talking about.
10 points of arena damage across the board. As the adrenaline from the crowd and the entire arena itself and the waves begin to rock back and forth. Captain.
I can see?
You can. At the end of your turn, you can see.
Are the ships anchored?
Not really. I mean, they're just kind of floating here. It's not real deep water, probably 10, 15 feet.
I take the helm of the burning ship and grin madly. And I'll cast Gust to get it moving. And I'm going to try to bring the bow around and strike the other ship, like, right there.
Gust. Cantrip? First level spell? What is this?
It's a cantrip.
What does it say? I like it. Give me a... You go to the helm, you pull into position, you do the gust.
Is it not an action to control the ship and an action to cast the gust?
It's an action to do the gust, and then we were doing ships as bonus actions, interacting with that object. Let's see. You know what? Give me a check with your spellcasting modifier. I will say that, so Gust is a very, very, very light cantrip. It doesn't move anything more than 5 pounds. But it is enough to get, I will say it's enough to just start, make the ship start to move. And then you're also moving in there and trying to get the ship to go into position. You're trying to ram it into the other ship. Is that what's happening, or what are you trying to do? I don't think Gust is going to be powerful enough to do that. Even with a 16. But I will say that you are able to drive the ship and have it hit the other one. They connect. And I would like a dexterity save from Iberia and Yar. As the ship starts to move and they hit one another.
7.
I would like to use my luck.
From the natural one?
On my natural one that I just rolled, yes, I would like to use my luck that I've been holding on to this whole time.
Oh.
Oof, that's still bad. 6.
Not a whole lot better. The ship moves just enough so they hit. It surprises the both of you. And Iberia and Yar, I will say that you both fall into the water. As they both smash into each other.
We fall into the water?
It's jarring.
At 5 miles per hour?
At 5 yeah. miles an hour. It is just, wow. just jarring enough.
Look, don't question the DM. I'm not questioning him anymore.
You both fall into the water.
This is how it is. This is how it is written. This is how it is to be.
And then that's your action, bonus action, and some of your movement. Captain, you got anything else?
Some of my movement, yes.
You could probably get to the mast, but the whole ship is on fire now. Basically, both ships are on fire now.
There is no safe place. I start climbing the mast.
You start climbing the mast, and you take 9 points of fire damage.
Yep.
And so, the captain, do you have any last words as you climb this mast?
This ship is going to sink like a lead weight.
And it is starting to fall, and the pieces are starting to fall down. And the captain itself lands on, starts climbing. The mast falls with him. He lands in the ground, burning, unconscious. Stumpy, you're all, the whole thing is on fire. What are you doing?
There be sand on the edge. Yes.
On the edge of the map. Yes, technically speaking.
Wonderful. Stumpy's going to reach down to his legs, reattach them. They crank and they bend in the middle as they turn into more of a grasshopper-style leg. And I'm going to cast Jump on Stumpy. Stumpy's going to run specifically past Theodore as he shifts from the sword back to his shield and his pepper box. And he is going to leap from the ship and onto the shore.
Jump off the boat and onto the shore, Theodore, as he leaves your range. You can take the opportunity attack if you want.
I would love to.
That will miss.
You
would love to, but you're not today. Stumpy, you close that distance, you land on the sand, and that is your that's action and movement and everything, right?
Yes.
All and, right. I've never seen anyone
Crank
cast
be
jump.
Following right behind me, and Crank is going to attack Theodore.
The bird, the parrot, bird? The parrot. I've never seen anyone use jump in game.
we had a lightning lure, a jump. You had also.
I'd be special.
Special.
Fifteen to hit.
That's not going to be enough. I swat the bird away. Get out of here.
All right, that ends your turn, Stumpy. Yar!
How deep is this water?
The water is pretty steep. And as you get into it, the sharks see you moving. And they start moving towards you and move towards you and Iveria both. It's about 15, 10 feet deep. It's like a swimming pool.
Is this disadvantage for attacks then? Or
yes. Because well, it depends on the weapon you're using. Depends on what you're using and stuff like
obviously
that.
Obviously a battle axe.
Yeah, for sure.
I can make my way all the way to Stumpy.
Yeah. You want to swim out?
Yeah, I'm swimming out.
As you start to move, the sharks see you. As you get out of the water, you take 14 points of piercing damage as one comes across and grabs you in the leg.
That's rude.
I know. 14 points. Oh, are you really?
Yeah.
Oh, no. So you try to move out, and a shark comes by, grabs you in the leg, rips it, and you start to bleed out.
That's how I lost me legs as well.
Oh!
Theodore.
Things are looking pretty grim here.
And you're on fire.
I'm still on fire?
The boat's on fire.
The whole ship is on fire, mate.
All right, cool. Let me see here. What can I do? What can I do? For my action, it's a bonus action. I'm going to bonus action Mass Healing Word on my team.
All right. So with that, go ahead and roll that healing. Captain, you stand up. Yar, you stand up, and you're both conscious again.
It ain't much, but they both get 5 points back.
5 points is 5 points. Five points as you come to consciousness.
All right, that leaves me with my movement and my action. Okay. sorry. Let's see. How far? What is it? I guess I can't jump that. If I get in the water, the sharks are going to attack me?
You're getting the cyst, that's true. They're going to attack you.
Okay. I just use my... Well, this is quite a predicament.
It is not good.
Let me see. Yeah, I don't... Oh, man. Okay. Well, I will... I guess I'll stay on the boat for as long as I can. Looking over at Stumpy, he's... how far away is he, would you say?
He's probably 15 feet from you.
15 feet from me? I'm going to attempt to lightning lure him back into the water.
Okay. Roll a hit, or dex save, right?
Strength save, actually.
Strength save, Stumpy.
Oh, Stumpy's not good at these.
Oh, no.
Shocker. The man with no legs isn't good at strength saves.
That'd be a 14.
He saved by one.
Yeah!
Oh, no. So
he saved by one.
Stumpy be blessed by the gods of blood.
That's rough.
You chose the wrong gods to be blessed with.
I didn't get blessed by any gods this game.
The blood gods have severely messed up Team Blue this game.
You know what? Sensing that this is coming to an end, I don't want to leave this arena without using my action surge. So I'm going to action surge and try it again.
And again.
Let's get another strength save out of you, Stumpy.
All right.
I believe.
See it.
That's an 8.
Yarr! Alright, so that's gonna fail. The lightning whip wraps around you and yanks you, how much is it? Is it 10 or 15 feet?
I think it's 10 feet.
10 feet in a straight line towards me, and you take a die-8 of lightning damage, or 2 die-8 of lightning damage, because I'm high level.
2 die-8 of lightning damage.
7 points of damage, and you are now 10 feet closer to the boat in the water.
You get pulled, and you get pulled, and you hit the boat, you fall in the water, and as you do, a shark comes by and bites at you. You take 16 points of piercing damage as it rips into one of your legs and tries to rip it off of you. All right, that is your turn, Theodore. End of your turn, you'll take... 7 points of fire damage.
Alright.
Patches!
I'll shoot this fool for using evil magic on my boat. I use my bonus action and Zephyr Strike. And I shoot him twice with a crossbow.
Who?
You attempt to shoot.
Theodore?
Theodore.
Okay.
A 23!
Shield?
Another one.
A natural 20!
Does a natural 20 hit?
Shield?
Shield, please!
Can I counterspell this?
You should use reaction for shield, so no.
That's with advantage, B. Because of Zephyr Strike.
Oh, well.
Alright, that'll hit. Go ahead and roll damage.
Yep.
So, do I roll double dice or is it
double dice?
All right. So I got the D8, double 2.
Double the Zephyr. Double the everything.
The attack be 22 damage. It be
22 damage, and with that, Theodore will fall to his knees and kind of lean over the ship, and he coughs out a little bit of blood. Probably falls on Stump's head.
Sharks
says,
like it.
Yeah. And he says, a true child of the sea, I return to thee. And he falls over dead.
Falls over dead.
Looks like you chose the wrong team.
I got you, me boy. Better me, or better you than me. And I'll push him under the water towards the sharks.
The sharks hit him for 14. He takes 2 death saves. Two fails.
I have an attack left, so I'll shoot the cabin.
Oh, I didn't say I fell in the water. I'm still on the boat.
Oh, you're still on the boat? Okay, the fire's going to get you. Never mind. Captain is prone on the ground. Roll disadvantage.
Oh, you said you fell on my head. No, I said I coughed blood on your head.
Oh, so it's just gross. It's not like...
Yeah.
Does an 18 hit, Captain?
Is this a flavor?
Finally, something missed.
No!
Oh, that attack misses. Alright, that ends your turn, Patches. Iveria.
I got movement.
Sure, what do you want to go ahead and move?
Can I get off this boat that's on fire?
Sure, you want to jump off the boat?
Yeah, can I make it to the land here?
You cannot, it's too far.
With 60 feet of movement?
I mean, you'd have to jump over you, which you don't have an action to do anymore. You can basically just fall off the boat.
My god, I'll stay on the boat.
You can walk off the boat.
Alright, you stay on the boat and take 5 points of fire damage. Iveria, you're looking around, you see Yar get eaten by these sharks, but he stands back up thanks to some divine magic from our dear Theodore. Start your turn, a shark comes up and bites you as well. You take 12 points of piercing damage.
I spit blood out of my mouth. Hold on. I take my 12 damage, spitting blood out of my mouth, and looking up at the little minnow in front of me. And and she will say, "No need to be measured for your chains, darling. You'll be cut to fit any gibbet cage when I'm done with you." And she will, while swimming, she will just, like, that black darkness will enter her eyes once more and just pour down her tattoos and down her face and down into the water. And she will use dissonant whispers on Yar.
Dissonant whispers.
In his mind, he will see, he will just look in the water and he will see, like, these hollowed, emaciated bodies, like the Inferi from Harry Potter, coming up out of, like, swimming up towards him to grab his legs and pull him into the depths of the ocean.
Better than the sharks.
That is a wisdom save, please.
Oh, I'm really terrible at those. Oh, I'm extra terrible at those. That is just a 2.
A 2 fails. A 2? That fails. So you will take...
I'm dead.
Yeah.
You're for sure dead.
Again.
You fall unconscious as our
Yar.
Oh man.
The blood gods attempt to turn the tides. Spell opponent casts a curse on Team Red.
The first Team Red. I fear it may be too little too late. But thank you, Spell Component, for the gift.
Look, we'll take what we can get at this point.
The blood gods are wise.
And I will go back on shore. Or I will go to the shore.
Team Red, you are now... all of you receive a -1 to your AC for the duration of the combat.
All right.
As Spell Component...
I see you, Luke. I see you.
with that will end... that one's your turn, Iveria. Captain! It's your turn.
Am I dead?
Not yet. You're prone on the ground.
You have 5 hit points.
Yeah, 5 hit points.
Alright. I had this whole thing. I was like, I'm not gonna be able to do it, but it'd be cool. But I'm gonna do it. So
do it!
Go for it, Captain. I believe in
you. So the boats aren't necessarily where they are anymore, are they?
They are not. Hang on. Let me give you a better representation of it. It kind of looks like a little bit like this. Looks a little bit like that now.
Oh, that's perfect. So I'm here right now, right?
Yeah.
Where can I go so that I don't take fire damage while I do this?
The water.
Yeah.
Or the sand.
The water.
So if I take a running start and then jump off of the ship, I'm still going to be taking fire damage?
Only if you end your turn here. Yeah.
Oh, okay. This is fine then.
This is fine.
So, it's going to be interesting.
It's literally that meme with the dog sitting with the cup. It's
yes, fine. This is fine.
It's fine. Yeah, yeah. This is fine.
Captain Grohl weighs like 600 pounds because he was designed to sink to the bottom of the ocean. So he runs along here and then like over here, and he uses his Tempest Sorceress thing to jump 10 feet into the air.
As don't, you the, above, don't you have to cast a spell to do that?
No, it's a bonus action.
It's an ability, yeah.
So he gets to there, he boosts up into the air and fires his cannonball where he's about to land, which is on top of Patches.
No!
So hopefully, even if he dodges, this will punch a hole in the ship, and then I'll land on top of it, and it should take the whole front of the ship into the water.
Oh no, he's taking
you want to take the whole ship down.
Well, I want to break off the
front end of the ship.
You're right. You're right, Jesse. It is. You have to cast a spell with it before or after, but he is doing that with catapult. So you jump up and you basically just like take the whole thing down with you. Make a dex save for me, Patches.
Never let go, Patches. Never let go.
My god, a 14.
My god. Well, that succeeds.
All right, so you're able to dodge it. It bursts. It knocks the whole front piece back, and the bow of the boat, just the corners knocked off. But coming down is Gruul on this fiery ship, and as he comes down onto you and breaks the ship as well, it smashes the whole front end. Make another deck save.
I use my inspiration.
Yeah, finally! Gruul. Thank you for remembering.
Gruul, you take 3 points of fall damage.
I rolled a 21.
Alright, so you take half of 6, which is 3 on for you, Gruul, for you, Patches, as the whole front ship breaks off and you both fall into the water as the whole front bow of the ship breaks down and you both land in the water. No longer on fire, but it's going to be rough for your boy, Captain. Captain, the sharks are coming for you. How many hit points do you have left?
Not enough.
Not enough.
Yeah.
Do you, the hunter sharks are coming for it. Do you want to give a description for how they destroy you?
He knew this was coming. He knew from the moment he saw this arena how this was going to play out. So he just like he unintegrates his armor and says, they ain't gonna be able to patch this up.
Oh no!
Hugs Patches to him and then reintegrates the armor around him.
I love it.
So that all of the pieces of his clothing are getting stuck in this thing. And then he takes his power core and like twists it so that all of his like sorceress thunder energy, all of his power cells, like he starts to short circuit and his armor arcs from all the connections. And then the sharks come in. And I'm not sure if you can breathe underwater.
I could definitely breathe underwater, mate.
Captain, as you do this,
it's like a piece of toast that's been put in a toaster and then thrown in the water.
It's thrown.
Way I'll die, I absorb elements.
You take 14 points, Captain, you take 13 points of piercing damage from the sharks. Patches, you take 14.
Still enough.
Captain, you take. Captain took 13. Patches takes 14 points of piercing damage from the sharks.
I'm still alive.
Still alive, and you're effectively restrained. But with our dear captain falling unconscious, that will effectively end this Iron Valor. Well done, everyone. Well done. A new
we
captain.
Have won! Huzzah! I want to hear it in chat. Huzzah!
A new captain has been made and named this day. Our Ivira reborn. You have anything for us? Captain?
Oh, I do. I have not won this day, and not you individually. It is us that have won together. There is a new dawn. We will sail the seas on the Blood Phoenix, and all shall hear our names. Huzzah! Huzzah!
I have two eyes!
And finally, the new captain is named, and a new scourge of the sea is
on its way. Well done, everyone. Excellent effort. Let's do our giveaway real quick.
Haven't entered, please do. Remember, it is command loot. If you want to pop up that screen again, Daniel.
Yeah, so we're giving away this really cool, awesome shirt, the Tail Weaver. Make sure you give that command loot to make sure that you're available. Congratulations to Team Red. I feel slightly that it was a little biased. There was a lot of curses on Team Blue and a lot of benefits to Team Red. So sorry to everyone on Team Blue. Life is hard. But the Blood Gods have spoken, and dominance has been established. Thank you to Mini Matt and for the follow, and Dapper Gent for the cheer for all those bits. And you can see us here every Wednesday at 7:30 as we play Iron Valor, and we continue to have some exciting games and some exciting battles. Fridays at 8 o'clock, we run Short Rest, which is where we play some games. We talk about Iron Valor. We talk about Fate's End, which is our live play show, and that sort of thing as well. So you can check us out there. We'll be there Friday at 8 o'clock. And, of course, if you haven't seen it yet, check out the Fate's End. Those VODs are available on Twitch. You can get in on the story now. Podcast format or here on the VODs. Fate's End is a super fun show. Brandon Davis and I, Lauren, is our DM. Super duper fun, a great show. It's starting to get interesting over there, so go check that out as well. And we're also going to do a raid here in just a second.
Pick our winner real quick.
Yeah, let's get a winner.
Starboy Goku.
Great name.
Starboy Goku.
You are the winner.
Well done. Well done, Starboy Goku. I think I know who that is, and no one deserves it more than her. And she deserves some swag.
Wear it with pride, lassie. Wear it with pride.
She deserves some swag at some point. It's been too long that she does not have a shirt. Okay, so let's see. Lauren, do you want to pick us out a raid? While we do, Jesse, thank you so much for joining us in this. I'm super thankful to have you here with us today.
Yeah, thank you guys for having me. It was fun.
My God, Stump was amazing.
Yeah.
Stump was great.
Everyone.
Lucky 300-pound roly-poly pirate.
It was pretty awesome with the role play there. I was very impressed.
Yeah, it was fun.
So, well done, everyone. You guys did great. Thank you, everyone who joined us in the chat. Everyone who... did you guys like the curses? What did you think about that? Was it good? Was it bad? All you guys over there. I know they're expensive, but it is what it is, you know?
Yeah, we want to hear from you, chat. What did you think of the curses and the blessings and all that?
Yeah.
Tell us. We want to know. There's a lag, so it'll take a second.
We do. That was like 15 seconds ago, so like... loved it from Dapper Gen. Of course he did. Ooh, that's a great question. Now a hidden mod, amazing. Love a good curse. I don't know. The curses, they may have been too powerful.
You might need to do like a universal cooldown where only one person can redeem.
I think what it is we just can't have it can't affect the whole team like that. That was rough.
Yeah, when you said the whole team, I was like, okay.
Hey, but that's what, you know.
Like Welsh.
You know what? That's why we do this. You know, we test it out. We see how it works, and you know, we're all joining in on this kind of together. So that's just kind of the way it goes. You know, sometimes they're good, sometimes it's bad. I think it was super fun, but it may have been a little bit too much for what we had. But we'll figure that out. All the curses, more curses. I'm gonna make a D100 table. If you have a curse you'd like to suggest, go ahead and put that in chat.
Curse inspiration.
Put that in the chat.
I think it would also be fun to do like funny curses where it's like you can only speak in a certain way or you can only move in like left or something. Like silly things, you know, not necessarily inherently, you know, crippling, but like silly, you know, that might be fun too. I don't know. Maybe that's just me, but.
Sure. All right. Who are we raiding, honey?
All right. So again, when we're going to raid this group for just a second, just give them some love, share some emotes, and tell them that Ink and Liar sent you. We're about to do a Blood God raid. We're going to be raiding Fabled 42. So here we go. In 9, 8, thank you again for joining us. 5, 4, 3, 2.
Bye. 1.
Huzzah! Let's raid!
Let us raid.
Let us raid.
Raid Shadow Legends.